heavy no man.
Are you a winner? 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 Woo! Huh? Sangalam, 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 sangalam. Woo! Glory to Jesus! Luwe! 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 Can I hear you scream unto our God? Somebody say hallelujah! Today is the day 3, final day. Come on, give it to Jesus. God bless you, God bless you, God bless you, God bless you. Come on, give it to Jesus. Huh? Huh? Come on, today is the day 3. Today is the day 3 and the final day. God has been so wonderful. We are so blessed. We are so blessed. We have so fortified ourselves. We are untouchable. We are unmovable. We are for signs and wonders. The Lord that has kept us is going to do a marvelous things for us. No matter what it is that the world is going through, it's not going to come near us. Please go ahead and share. Post a watch party. Eh? I don't want you naked, Mo. I don't want you naked, me. Eh? God bless you. God bless you, Florence. God bless you, Waki. God bless you, ID. God bless you, Imelda. God bless you, Nsika. God bless you, Ben Hasley. God bless you, Suleiman. God bless you. God bless you. Please go ahead and share us the watch party. I want you to share for at least 7 people. Share to at least 7 groups. Write people's name for them to tune in. Our God is wonderful. Just do it for the first few minutes. Today is our last day for the anointing oil service. Our last day of the anointing oil service. If you were not here in day 1, you were not here in day 2, you were not here in day 3. Begin to celebrate God. Today, by the grace of God, if everybody goes ahead and share, that means I will be calling people and be praying with them. But if you're not sharing and I don't see sharer by your name, that means I'm just going to bless the anointing oil and we are done. So if you want us to pray together, please go ahead and share. So far I see just 29 shares. So in CDB, make sure you're sharing. Vitalis, please share. Saha Simeon, please share. Adama, share. Host the watch party. To give it to your word. I have come to give back to you. Oh. God bless you. God bless you. Hi, Maka Mirabel. Go ahead and share. God bless you, my daughter. I have come to give back unto you. Come and say you have come to give back to the Lord all that he has given you. For the past 3 days, the God has been so good to us. And now we are coming to say thank you, Jesus. Just say, Father, I am here to give back to you. Say thank you to you. You deserve all the praise.
to
give you back to your. Come on, say you have come to say thank you to Jesus. I have come to say thank you to you. I have come to say thank you to you. Come on, somebody say, I've come to say thank you to the Lord. To save your hands to you. I want to see somebody lift their hands to the Lord. Thank you, Lord. To say thank you to you, Lord. If you're grateful, just wave your hand and say, I have come to say thank you to you, Lord. Praise, take all the praise, take all the praise you deserve. The praise, take all the praise, take all the praise. Come to say thank you, Lord. I have come to say thank you. Please come on, guys, go ahead and share so that we can start. We need to have 50 people there to start. Are you guys not sharing? Have you been blocked? Happy weekend to everyone. Today is a day three, final day. Hey, thank you, Lord. Oh, thank you, Lord. Just take all the praise. Praise. Take all the 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 praise. You deserve it, Jesus. Praise. So 6 more people for us to start. Hey, take all the praise. God bless you, God bless you. 3 more people to start. Take all the praise. Halbert, Mariam, everybody that is just tuning in, go ahead and share. Usenebon, go ahead and share. Princess Colbert, go ahead and share. Albert, go ahead and share. Apiok Deng, go ahead and share. Destiny Brown, go ahead and share. Just tell the Lord that he should take all the praise. Since we started from day one till today, God has been faithful. Let him take all the praise. Let him take all the worship. Let him take all the adoration. Because he deserves it. He deserves it. He deserves it. Him alone deserves all the glory. Him alone deserves all the glory. Him alone deserves all the honor and adoration. Okay. God bless you. God bless you. Benjoah Jehovah. I'm just hosting a watch party. I'm hosting a watch party. So I'm encouraging everyone to do the same thing. Write your friend's name on the comment section. People that you want them to be here and they are not here, just write their name on the comment section and they are gonna come. We thank the Lord that has made it possible for us to gather on this final day. To gather on this final day, the day three of our anointing service. God bless those that are commenting to the video. God bless those that are reacting to the video. God bless those that are sharing the video. God bless those that are inviting someone. You are the next to be announced. You are the next to be announced to your world. You are the next to be announced to your world. Come, let's dance to the Lord. 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 Yeah, 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 ilele, ilele, ilele. Come, let's dance to the Lord. Yeah, yeah, ilele, yeah, 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 yeah. Come, let's dance to the Lord. Now in Zimbabwe language, ugo, ugo, ugo. Over there is ugo, 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 ugo. Huh? If you're ready to say over there with me, say ugo, 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 ugo. Ugo, 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 ugo. 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 Ugo, 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 ugo. 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 Do we have the South Africans here? Ugo. 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 Eh? God bless you. God bless you. God bless you. Hi, Maria. You're welcome. Happy weekend. Hi, Chukbeng. God bless you. Hi, Destiny Ido. God bless you. Hi, Subin. God bless you. If I just called your name, it means that you have not shared the progress. So go ahead and share. Eh? Huh? Come, let's dance to the Lord. Come, let's dance to the Lord. Come, let's dance to the Lord. Eh? Come, let's dance to the Lord. Eh? Come, let's dance to the Lord. Come, let's dance to the eh? Yeah, 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 you come less than to the Lord. Hey! Come on, are you dancing? Oh my God! Glory to Jesus. It is so nice to worship God. It is so nice to see people go crazy for God. You need to see what the guy is dancing here. You need to see how this guy is moving his body. He says, when I say ugo, ugo, touch your head. When I say ugo, ugo, hold your waist. And when I say ugo, ugo again, then you turn around, touching your head and your waist. And you are turning around. You're turning around. Oh my God. It's so amazing, eh? And I'm just seeing the people wasting the dance there, because if I am there, the way I'm going to shake my waist, it is incredible. God bless us. God bless us. We are going to start. Today is the final day. Day 3 of 3 of the anointing service. God bless you wherever you're watching me from. Happy weekend to you. I bless you in the name of God, the Father, Son, and the Holy Spirit. It is a wonderful moment that God has made it possible for us to gather again. You know, today, a lot of things happened yesterday. So after I finished the live broadcast, my internet wasn't working. And I had this phobia of staying on the phone for so long, right? I always tell you guys, I don't like staying on the phone for so long. So I was actually anticipating how I'm going to call TELUS, and I'm just going to be, that's my internet provider, TELUS. How I was going to call them, and I was just going to be on the phone with them for that long. So I didn't want to call them because somebody's watching from Togo, Kingsley Odo God bless you in Togo. Please go ahead and share for the people in Togo. And Melody is watching from Luca, Mrs. Misapi. Misapi. Mama, thank you, Lord. Mama, you called my Robbie Sevilla. Mama, you make my... Clover Davison. How do you know her? Ruby... Sullivan. Yes, I actually said I was gonna check up on her. How is she faring? She was complaining about her BP yesterday, and I said as soon as she drinks the water, her BP was going to come back, come down. How is she faring? Wow, good thing that you know. I am watching from Jamaica. God bless you. God bless you. God bless you. God bless you. Please endeavor to share for the people in your location. Share for the people in your location. For whoever shared the video, that was why Ruby was able to get in contact with me. So you see, while it is always good to share the broadcast, right? Somebody else who needs prayer will just contact. God bless the one that is reacting to the broadcast. God bless the ones that are sharing. God bless everyone. So I was just thinking how I was going to stay on the line with Tellus all day. Because those guys can take like 4 hours. Sometimes 6 hours before they pick up your call. So throughout yesterday, I didn't have internet again. And I was like, wow, God is wonderful. If I have not done the broadcast that yesterday, I wouldn't have been able to do the broadcast. Thank God that there was somebody in the house with me. So I had to share the hotspot. I had to share the person's hotspot. And this morning, I called and then they fixed my internet. Because I was so worried. I was like, how are we going to have our last service? Today is the last day of this service. It will not be good if this service is postponed. It will not be good if this service is delayed. It will not be good if this service does not go in line with the other 2 days. Father, just make it possible. Anyhow, Lord, you're going to do it. I just need internet so that I will do my service today, because I really needed to complete this service. So they brought back, I called them. First thing in the morning before 6 a.m., I've already called them and they picked up and they attended to me. And here we are. My internet is working. I can see comments today. That means my internet is very good. I can see comments today. And for most of the people that I was praying for, if you notice at any point of in time at the night, I wasn't live, I wasn't online, that means that my internet went off on me whilst I was chatting you. And that's notwithstanding. The good thing is that I am back. To God be the glory. Happy weekend to you. Happy Saturday today. I hope everybody is not really feeling the pain of the pandemic. I hope everyone is not so isolated. I hope everybody is not going through hard time. I want you guys to do something. Like in this season, you need to take it a day at a time. Otherwise, so many people are going to go down during the pandemic. Just the thought of listening to what is going on in the world. I put on my TV this afternoon in my room and I was listening to the death record in Italy. And I'm like, my God, people are just dying like guinea fowl. People are dying like chicken. People's lives are being wasted like nothing. It is time for God to show that land mercy. I cover every child of God in the land of Italy, in the country of Italy, in the city of Italy, in the province of Italy. I covered all God's children, the beloved of Christ, in that country with the precious blood of the Lamb. That your life shall not be wasted. That nobody will shed tears because of you. You will not be cut off like the dim light, just like that. Nothing shall waste you. You are covered. You are protected. You are exempted. You are not limited to whatever is affecting the world. You are different. God has put a mark on you, and you are demarcated from whatever affliction it is that the devil has afflicted the world with. So when you are praying, please pray for that country, Italy. They need the prayer most. The pandemic is so much in their place. The death record is so much in Italy. Do not say because you do not have families, you do not have relatives. How about your friends? How about people that you know are about my children in the Lord. So just pray for them, just pray for them. The pandemic record is really high on their side. It's really, really, death records is really high on their side. So let us learn to pray for Italy. As we put our knee down, let us learn to pray for them. I said something the other day. I said, just pick a country. Like, you can pick up China, you can pick up Italy, like, just those ones that the pandemic is really great and the death record is rampant. Just pick them up and pray for them, intercede for them. And I want to show you something, that God listens to prayer. God hears us when we call upon him. And I don't want you to lose hope at this season. I don't want you to lose hope at this period. I don't want you to give up at this period. And you need to be careful. Let it not be because you have been isolated. Let it not be because you have been restricted. Let it not be that because the social gathering has been held on restrictions, people are now sitting home and just eating and adding weight. And then they are not going to like themselves. And then they are not going to fancy how they are. Just make sure that you're doing one activities or the other. If you're the type that gyms, make sure that you keep doing your gym. You can do an indoor gym. It doesn't mean until you go outdoor before you can get yourself gymed. You can stay in and do some skipping. You can skip with the skipping ropes. You can just take a walk. Don't just lie in bed. That's the bone of contention. Don't just lie in bed. Like, just take a walk around. Your neighbor will just out and in. Even if you do 1 kilometer going, 1 kilometer coming back, you have done something. Just burn down some calories. Burn down some calories, or you watch what you eat. Right? The best way is watching what you eat. I'm not really, really the gym kind of a person. I'm not really, really the exercising kind of a person. But once in a while, I make sure that I occupy myself with house activities. That way, that's how I exercise. Like, I'm not the type who just wakes up, sits in the house like that. I burn. I can walk around the house like 10, 50 times in a day. Just moving around like that, getting myself occupied with something. That way, I don't store up fats. That way, I burn my calories. It's not just about burning your calories. It's about being healthy, right? You need sometimes to exercise those bones. You need sometimes to do those exercise so that it works for your kidney, for your liver, for your cells, for your bloodstreams, right? It can flow. And then you are healthy and you are active. And you can also sleep well. You can also sleep well. So it is very essential at this time that, irrespective of the fact that you are not doing the social gathering, don't say, oh, my only way of exercising is in the club. Don't say my only way of exercising is in the with friends. You're not going to be doing those things. I even heard that Mother's Day, Grandmother's Day, Grandmother's Birthday, friends' birthday and all of that. It's not necessary, like, you just go and visit them. If it's not worth doing, like, if it's not an emergency, there's no point. Just call people up on the phone, talk to them, do video, whatever, and they see you, right? We can be together, like right now. You're seeing me on the video and we are worshiping together. I am not in the United Kingdom. I'm not in the United States. I'm not in Nigeria. I'm not in Ghana. I'm not in Liberia. I'm not in Jamaica. I'm not in Malaysia. I'm not in Italy. I'm not at so many places that people wrote down. I'm not at India. But we are doing something together, but at different places and at different time zones. So we can also do the same thing with our phone, right? We can just call up people. We can just do so. Let's not feel really isolated. Because when we feel isolated, then we are going to set into depression. When we begin to think too much, we are going to go down to depression. And once we start having depression, and when we are not actively engaged, then our lifespan goes down automatically. I don't know how many of you knows this. I don't know how many of you knows that when you are not happy, your life gets to a pass. How many of you knows that it affects your growth, your health growth, when you are not happy? Chuku, God bless you. You're very welcome, my son. Go ahead and share. I also see Chimobim. Chimobim, I was supposed to add you to groups. I'm very sorry. Please remind me after the broadcast. Just keep reminding me until I add you to groups. Or Chimobim, you can be very smart. After the broadcast, you will see the groups that I've shared. You will just click on the groups and you will join. Chimo Bim, just share. Host a watch party. Joy Omos, as you come in, I might not mention your name, but just know that you're welcome into God's presence. So don't set into depression. When you are not happy, it affects your immune system. Anytime you are not happy, it affects your immune system. It takes just few muscles for you to smile. Few muscles for you to smile. But it takes a lot for you to frown. For you to frown and be sad and be angry. It takes a lot of muscles, a lot of strength, a lot of energy, a lot of negativity for you to put that into order. So if you want to look young, even at 40, when you tell people I'm 40, people would say, you are lying. If I tell you guys how old I am, you would think I'm lying. But why do I look this way? It is because I'm always happy. It is because I know how to take care of myself. It's because I am conscious of the things I eat. It's because I know how to carry myself. Like, I don't eat anything that comes my way. I know what to eat at the right time, and I know when not to eat. I know the things to avoid. I'm not the type who wants to eat everything. So as we are staying home this time around, let us apply caution. You know, for ladies, it is not good for you to wear clothes. I'm not wearing sleeveless, so you might not really understand what I'm talking about. But I want to give you some beauty tips. That can make you look good for yourself. Sometimes it's not about looking good for a man. Sometimes it's not about looking good for anybody. It's about feeling good for yourself. It's about building your self-confidence. Maybe I will come on to talk about this some other time. Since it was an anointing oil service, I will just center on the anointing oil service. And next time, after this broadcast, the next time I'm coming on live, I'm going to be educating you guys on how to stay healthy. All of these things is in the scripture. The Bible says that thou mayest prosperous and stay in good health. That means this was one of God's wishes for us. Why did God want us to stay in good health? So that we will be beautified, so that we will look cheeky, so that we will look attractive, so that we will look like the angels in heaven. So you don't need to store much fat that you will be seeing fat all over here. When you are wearing sleeveless, you will see fat here, you will see breast fat here, and then you will see breast popping out like that. No. You need to package yourself. You need to beautify yourself. So the next time I'm going to be live, I'm going to be talking about how to carry yourself as a man, as a lady, how to carry yourself. Some of you guys, you wear boxers. You don't even wear boxers. You wear your trousers like that and be dangling. I don't know for whoever case to see, because I don't know what you're showcasing. I don't know what you're selling. So it is essential as believers, as children of God, for us to learn how to carry yourselves, so that even at 40, you're still looking chic. You're still looking chic. You're still looking beautiful. You know, sometimes people come up to tell you guys essential things. Essential things that if you're to go to your doctor, you pay for consultation. If you're to go and meet a nutritionist, you pay for consultation. But I tell you guys this thing for free. I'm a medical doctor. So when I tell you something, take it, write it down, practice it. It is not about what you have. It is about what you eat. It's about how you carry yourself. It doesn't matter if you have one cloth, but that one cloth you have can save you a purpose than somebody who has a lot but doesn't know what to wear at the right time. So you guys got to appreciate yourself and take caution for this season, because you know what it is when you're staying home all day. You're not doing anything. The only thing you're exposed to is food. I know how tempting it is. And when you are eating, avoid sweets. Anything sweetened fattens. All those chocolates, all those burger, all those nonsense, all those junks, it fattens you. But if you cook your food at little quantity and at little things, then you see yourself blowing forward. Okay, so I just put that in real quick. Because, you know, I want to see people looking fresh. I want to see people looking healthy. I want to see people staying fit. I want to see people fit for the season. Above all, I want to see people fit for the season. So God bless you. If you're just tuning in and you haven't shared, I'm still there. telling you to share because that's what I'm doing. I want you to share because that's what I'm doing. Okay, so don't just eat anything you see. Avoid sweets so that you don't grow out of proportion, right? So that your weight is intact. And that way you love yourself. Your clothes are fitting. Sometimes you need to challenge yourself. If there are, you know, there are sometimes you have this beautiful jean, you have some mini skirts, you have some gowns that you really need to go back into that clothes. You love those clothes. You don't want to give them out. You want to go back into that clothes. Just challenge yourself and say, you know what? I'm going to fit back to this jean. So I want to. And above all, I want it to be fit for the gospel. If you're not healthy, you are not fit for the gospel. You need to be healthy. You need to be fit. You need to be strong for the gospel. Okay, guys. Okay. I love you guys like that. I love you guys like that. That's why I'm taking my time to give us these L tips to educate us. Because I love you like that. I want you to live long. I want you to live long. I want people to see you. I want you to live long. I want people to see you and envy you. I want people to see you and begin to ask you, how old are you? Why do you take so good care of yourself? And some people, they are so young, but they look so old, which is not good. You are supposed to look younger than your age. So if you're looking older than your age, God bless you. Saha. That is the right word. Love yourself before you can love someone else. Exactly. So if you don't even look at, if you don't love the way you are looking, it's impossible that you can love anybody else. Because you will always say, how come I'm like that? How come I'm like that? That's how you transfer it to people. So you must love yourself in order to be able to love people. God bless you for that contribution. That was a very good point. You must love yourself in order for you to be able to love other people. Let us open the section now. Father, we thank you. We worship you because you God. We give you the glory. We give you the honor because there is none like you. Father, we are here again today on the day 3 of the anointing oil service. Father, you did it for us the first day. You did it for us the second day. And today is our third day of the anointing service. Father, as we fellowship in your presence, we pray that you are going to come and you're going to be with us. Father, every word that we're going to hear from you, let it be to the benefit of us. Father, as you anoint us, we are free of every pandemic. We are free of everything that affects the world. Father, as we hear your word today, we know you're going to use your word and do great and mighty for us. We know that you're going to use your word to do wonderful things that we least expected. We know that you're going to use your word to set us free, to liberate us, to loose us, to deliver us. Father, in the mighty name of Jesus, as we have prayed, we know you will do even more than we have prayed because we are here. Father, for they that are sick, may they not leave this place the same. For they that are depressed, may they not leave this place the same. For they that are burdened in their hearts, may they not leave this place the same. For they that are, their marriages are broken, for they that are not looking for one thing or the other, Father, whatever the heart desires of your children, hey, as they are here today, Father, let it come to bear in the mighty name of Jesus. Let it come to bear in the mighty name of Jesus. Let it come to bear for them in the mighty name of Jesus. Amen and amen. So just in case today is your first day of joining us, it is our last day of the anointing service. So you need to get a little anointing oil, which we are going to pray and we are going to use afterwards. And I'm going to be telling you how we are going to be using it. But before that time, we're going to quickly look at the scripture. You guys know I don't do anything out of the ordinary. God bless you, Gillian. God bless you. Joshua, God bless you, woman of God, Jesus, Grace, God bless you, God bless you, God bless you, you're very welcome. Okay, if you can go ahead and share for me, if you're just tuning in, Gillian Carey said, just wanted to have my sick mom on oxygen just this evening. Father, in the mighty name of Jesus, wherever the sick mom is on oxygen, by the end of this broadcast, give Gillian Kiri a testimony and let her know that truly you are here. Father, I once said something. Jesus was here and I did not know. And you had said that as many that would come in, Lord, whatever it is that is not happening in heaven, it's not permitted to happen here. Today, I pray for the sick mother in oxygen that at the end of this broadcast, release a testimony for caring in the mighty name of Jesus. It is permanent and it is done in Jesus' mighty name. Amen. Okay, so today, the people that, my daughters are not here. So the people that are here, you guys are all going to be my daughters, right? The ushers are not here. I messaged Mira, Mira, I'll be going live in a moment. But I realized she didn't see. Okay, good thing Samuela is here. Good thing Adama is here. Sarah is here. The rest of you are just going to do the work. So volunteer yourself to work for God. And let us move really quick. Let us move really quick. Let us move really quick. So the first Bible question we're going to be taking today is going to be the book of Isaiah. We're going to be reading the book of Isaiah chapter 10 verses 27. Isaiah chapter 10 verses 27. Isaiah chapter 10 verses 27. Maggie Singley, I don't know if you saw my message. I dropped you a message yesterday. I don't know if you checked your inbox. And for those of you, Aisha, you were supposed to send your testimony. If I have not checked it, if you have sent it, I've not checked it, please don't worry. I will get back to you and post them as soon as I can. It's really not been very easy for me, but God is awesome in every situation. Okay, so Isaiah chapter 10, verses 27. Isaiah chapter 10, verses 27, I will read. And it shall come to pass in that day that his burden shall be taken away from off thy shoulder and his yoke from off thy neck, and the yoke shall be destroyed because of the anointing. It shall come to pass, and my other version says, so it will be in that day that his burden will be removed from your shoulder and his yoke from your neck, and the yoke will be broken because of the fatness. Today, in the name of Jesus, every yoke that was upon your shoulder, every burden that was upon your shoulder, every yoke that was upon your neck, today it shall be taken away by the power of the anointing. Every yoke shall be broken. Yoke of unmarriedness shall be broken. Yoke of lack of promotion shall be broken. Yoke of lack of healthiness shall be broken. Every yoke of the enemy, yoke of this pandemic shall be broken at the end of this broadcast in the mighty name of Jesus. The yoke of that lady that is lying down, that yoke of that sickness that she is under the oxygen right now, by the end of this broadcast, that yoke shall be broken in the name of Jesus. That yoke shall be broken in the name of Jesus. Eunice Williams, I hope you checked your inbox and see that I inboxed you yesterday as well as today. So the Bible is saying in Isaiah chapter 10 verses 27. Isaiah 10 27. I don't know what yoke is upon your shoulder. I don't know what burden is upon your life. I don't know what yoke is on your neck. Some of you, you have jolted. Some of you, you are broken. Some of you, you are shattered. Some of you, you are disappointed. Some of you, you are empty. Some of you, you are sick. Some of you, you need deliverance. Some of you, you need upliftment. Some of you, you need breakthrough. Whatever manner of burden, whatever manner of yoke that is upon you, by the end of this program today, every yoke shall be broken. Every burden shall be taken away. Why? Because of the power that is in the anointing. You need to know that anointing breaks every yoke. Anointing breaks every burden. Anointing breaks every protocol. Anointing breaks every manipulation. Anointing breaks every sickness. So whatever yoke it is that is upon your neck, whatever yoke it is you're carrying on your head, whatever yoke it is in your household, whatever yoke it is in your workplace, whatever yoke it is in your ministry, whatever yoke it is in your marriage, whatever yoke it is in your relationship, the Lord is taking it away from you. It shall not be upon you again in the mighty name of Jesus. It is not my scripture. It is the word of the Lord. And that is what he has said. He said, and it shall come to pass in that day. Today is that day.
Come on, somebody, personalize it and say, and it shall come to pass today, that I, Kate, the first lady of God, whatever yoke is upon my neck shall be broken. Whatever burden has been on my shoulder shall be broken today. It shall come to pass that in that day, you are going to remove in that day and put, it shall come to pass today, right now. It shall come to pass right now. I taught us something the other day on faith. I said faith is now. Some people can say faith is what? Faith is next week. Faith is tomorrow. Faith is, I don't care when. But for me, faith is now. I, Irene, go ahead and share. God bless you. I, Joyce, you're welcome. So faith is now. Whatever, it shall come to pass today, right now. My own is not even today. Right now, it shall come to pass. It shall come to pass right now that the burden shall be taken away off thy shoulder. Every burden that was on your shoulder is hereby taken off in the name of Jesus. Every burden that was on your shoulder is hereby taken off by fire in the name of Jesus. Every burden that was on your shoulder is hereby taken off by the precious blood of the Lamb in the mighty name of Jesus. There shall be no burden. There shall be no yoke over again in the name of Jesus. Every yoke that has stood in the past, every yoke that has stood yesterday, every yoke that was supposed to come tomorrow, today because of the anointing, today because of the power that is in the anointing, that yoke is broken. That burden is taken off your shoulder. In the name of Jesus, that yoke is broken. He says, by the mention of the name of the Lord, that every knee shall bow. Everything that was in your life that was not according to God's plan is hereby broken in the name of Jesus. I take off that burden off thy shoulder. I take that burden off thy shoulder. I take that burden off thy shoulder. I remove that yoke from your neck. I remove that yoke from your neck. Yoke of wickedness. Yoke of sorrow. Yoke of sickness. Yoke of disappointment. Yoke of stagnation. Yoke of difficulties. Yoke of sickness. Yoke of promise and fail. Yoke of delay. It is broken in the name of Jesus. It is broken in the name of Jesus. It is broken in the name of Jesus. That evil yoke, that when you get into something, you start very well, but you cannot end very well. That yoke is broken in the name of Jesus. That yoke of disappointment, it is broken in the name of Jesus. That yoke of delay, it is broken in the name of Jesus. That yoke of repetition of story and history in your family, it is broken in the name of Jesus. Every yoke that has stood on your way to success, every yoke that has stood to delay you in your marital settlement, every yoke that has stood in your business, every yoke that has stood in your business, every yoke that has stood towards the fruit of the womb for you, every yoke that has stopped you from being fruitful, today, right now, I break it in the name of Jesus. I break every yoke in the name of Jesus. I scatter every yoke in the name of Jesus. Every burden that escaped. You know, some places they said in this family, the firstborn, they are not successful. The firstborns, they are useless. The firstborns, they cannot make it in life. The firstborns, they must not go anywhere. The firstborn, they will struggle. Today, if you are the firstborn, every covenant over firstborns, I destroy them by the mighty hands of Jesus. Every evil covenant over the firstborns, today I destroy them in the name of Jesus. Every evil covenant over every firstborn, it is broken in the name of Jesus. Every evil burden that the witches and wizards kept on your neck, I carry them away in the name of Jesus. I carry that yoke in the name of Jesus. I break that burden in the name of Jesus. Your life shall never remain the same. In the mighty name of Jesus, your life shall never remain the same. In the mighty name of Jesus, your life shall never remain the same. In the mighty name of Jesus, your life shall never remain the same. In the mighty name of Jesus, I don't care who spoke into your life. I don't care the pronouncement of men. I don't know where you were cursed. I don't care to know where you were cursed, but today I come with the fire of the Most High God. Today I come with the voice of the Lord to announce to you that every yoke is broken, 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 that every yoke is broken. To the firstborn, I break every yoke. To every male child, I break every yoke. To every female child, I break every yoke. That yoke that is making you unsuccessful, that yoke that cannot release your visa, that yoke that cannot release your documents, that yoke that cannot release your marriage, that yoke that cannot release your good luck, that yoke that is delaying your case, that yoke that is making them to tell you to come. Today they keep postponing. Other people that you met in that situation, they have gone out of that situation since, but you are still there. Evil yoke of the enemy is not allowing you to move forward. It is like a force that is pushing you back. Anytime you want to go forward, there is a force that is pushing you back. Every evil yoke that pulls you out, even when you are meant to go forward, today I destroy them in the name of Jesus. Today I cancel them in the name of Jesus. Today I break their wings in the name of Jesus. Today I destroy them in the name of Jesus. Today I demolish them in the name of Jesus. Today I neutralize their powers in the name of Jesus. Every yoke that has stood in your life, today I break them by the power of the Most High God. In Jesus' mighty name. You started a business since 2017. People have done this business in 3 months. They have succeeded. But you keep changing businesses. Today you are selling shoes. Tomorrow you are selling clothes. Next tomorrow you are selling bag. Next time you're selling earring. Next time you're selling necklace. Before you know you're selling on this. Before you know you're selling shoes. You keep selling things. You keep changing business. Because of the evil yoke that is upon your life. Today I break that yoke. Today I break that yoke. Today I break that yoke. That yoke of confusion. That yoke of promise and fail. It is broken in the name of Jesus. It is broken in the name of Jesus. It is broken in the name of Jesus. The evil yoke that took away the destiny that God gave you. Today I call back your destinies. Today I call back your glory. Today I call back your stars. Today I call back your fortunes. Today I call back everything that God created you to be. In the name of Jesus, every yoke is broken. Every yoke is shattered. Every yoke is demolished. In the name of Jesus, evil yoke of pandemic shall not come near your dwelling place. Every yoke of the witches and wizards is hereby broken in the name of Jesus. Every yoke of your evil uncles and aunties, it is hereby broken in the name of Jesus. Every yoke that is not allowing you to be steadfast and know what you're doing in your life, today we break that evil yoke in Jesus' mighty name. You know, sometimes you are asking yourself, why is it that the people that are not even doing anything, they are not even struggling, they are the ones that their lives is so in line? I'm going to share a testimony with you guys right now. You guys know I always tell true life story. So there is this lady that I know. Maybe she was working in the past. But for so long as I know right now, that lady is not working. But I want to tell you guys something. The money that lady has, somebody that is working does not have that kind of money. What is she doing? She just sits down and collects money for people. She just sits down and collects money for people. And when she collects money for people, they give her the percentage. You can imagine telling me, woman of God, I want to use your account and collect money. And whatever money comes into this account, you take your percentage and you give them the rest. You can imagine. So if 20,000 comes in a week, how much is the money she has? It is nothing compared to somebody who is working. Somebody tell the Lord to open a way for you where there is no way. It is not by hard work that a man has made ends meet. It is not by how much you work. It is not by how much money you saved. It is a God's favor that locates a man and changes a man's story. It is God's favor. Whilst you are sleeping, people are busy making money for you. While you are at rest, you don't even need to stress. Nothing, it just comes. Why? Because it is the favor of God. And how can this favor of the Lord comes? It is when the yoke is broken. It is when the burden is taken off your neck. It is when the covenant that the Lord has spoken in his word comes to pass. Rikababashataya. Somebody, you did not hear me. Just look at the book of Isaiah. Isaiah is saying in chapter number 10, verses 27, he says, and it shall come to pass. And it shall come to pass in that day. Which day? Child of God, can you not personalize it and say, it shall come to pass today, 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 Lord. It shall come to pass today that the years of my crying is over, that the years of my sorrow is over, that the years of my snatching is over, that the years of my worry are over, that my year of sickness is over. It shall come to pass right now. It says, on that day, my God, somebody, you need to read your Bible. You need to read your Bible for yourself. Today, we are reading the book of Isaiah chapter 10, verses 27. And the scripture says, so it shall be in that day that his burden will be removed. Every burden of your lives, every burden that you have carried from your childhood till this day is hereby removed right now by the fire of the Holy Ghost. The Bible did not say anything. It said by the power that is in the anointing. If you know how powerful the anointing is, you will bath with the anointing. You will anoint your head with the anointing. You will drink the anointing. And you will anoint yourself with the anointing. And you will change and wear beautiful clothes. That's what we read the other day in the scripture. I don't know what burden it is that you've been going around with. Some of you, you came into the families that your evil uncles and aunties have sworn. And they have said, over their dead body will you make it. Over their dead body will you stumble. Over your dead body will you travel. Over their dead body will you marry. Over their dead body will you prosper in life. The Lord shall kill them for you to prosper. In the mighty name of Jesus. Anybody that says, over my dead body before your prosperity comes forth. Enough is enough. It is time for the Lord to take them away in order for your prosperity to surface. In order for it to surface, it is time for the Lord to take them away. It says, I don't know how long that yoke has stood. The yoke of confusion, the yoke of limitation, the yoke of stagnation, the yoke of disappointment, the yoke of failure, the yoke of sickness, the yoke of begging, the yoke of struggles. Some of us, we need to struggle. Some of us, our lives are full of struggle. Some of us, we beg to feed. Some of us, we beg to wear. Some of us, we borrow clothes. Some of us, we borrow shoes. Some of us, we borrow money. Everything about us is borrowing. Every limitation in your life, that any yoke from wherever it came from brought upon your life, today that yoke is taken away from you. You would break forth from every limitation. You are coming forth for every stagnation. You are coming forth from every disappointment. You are coming forth from every promise and fail. Everything that limited you in the past, today, 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 by the power that is in the anointing, you are breaking that yoke in the name of Jesus. You are breaking that bound in the name of Jesus. You are releasing your freedom in the name of Jesus. I don't know how you know the power that is in the anointing. I don't know what you believe by the yoke being taken away from your life. I don't know what you understand by the yoke being taken away from your neck. Some of us, we are carrying a yoke on our neck like a necklace. Some of us, we are carrying a burden on our shoulder as though we are carrying success. Some of us, we have been limited in every area of our lives. But today, I hear the Lord says, you are coming out of every struggles of your life. The Lord is saying that that yoke is taking off your shoulder. The Lord is saying that that yoke is taking off thy neck. He is saying that that burden is taking off your shoulder. I don't know what burden it is that was resting on your shoulder. I don't know what pain it is that that was resting on your shoulder. I don't know how many people you buried out of this pain. I don't know how many times you need to go down because of this pain. I don't know how many times you need to remain in that same story because of the burden that is upon your shoulder. Some of you, you are carrying burdens of your parents. You are carrying the burdens of your siblings. You are carrying the burdens of your community. You are carrying the burdens of your church. You are carrying the burdens of your children. People you know and people you don't know. You are just carrying the burdens of them. Today the Lord is releasing you from that burden. Today the Lord is releasing you from that burden. It doesn't matter how many cases you had. It doesn't matter where you were prayed for. It doesn't matter where you went for deliverance. But today I hear the Lord says, every yoke is coming out of your neck. Every burden upon your shoulder is hereby taken away. You are released from that responsibility. You are released from that bondage. You are set free from that limitation. You shall not continue to stay in that condition. People came last year. They associate you with a name. Because of your condition. They associate you with a name. Because of your story. They associate you with a name. Because of what is going on in your life. They have ascribed a name over you. Ah, that brother that is always proposing to women. But you will never have money to marry. Hey, that sister that is into 5 relationships, but none will come to pass. Hey, that sister that is always wearing 1 dress. Hey, that brother that is known with 1 trouser. It doesn't matter the kind of name you were ascribed to. But today, right now, I hear the Lord says, I will take away the yoke from thy neck. And I will take away the burden from thy shoulder. It doesn't matter how many years you were carrying that burden on your shoulder. It doesn't matter how long you have stayed on that burden. It doesn't matter how long you have stayed in that condition. But hear me, child of God, you are coming out strong and victorious. You are coming out a success. You are coming out victorious. You are coming out like a winner, man. You are coming out with a grand style. You are coming out with a testimony. You are coming out with glory. You are coming out because it's time for the Lord to set you free. He says, I do not need permission. He says, I do not need anything from nobody. When it is my time, it is my time. When I say yes, nobody can say no. When I say it's now, nobody can take it away. I hear the Lord says right now, that yoke is broken off your shoulder. I hear the Lord says right now, that burden is taken off your shoulder. I hear the Lord says right now, that limitation is broken. I hear the Lord say right now, that chain is broken. I hear the Lord say right now, there shall be no more delay. There shall be no more disappointment. There shall be no more failure. There shall be no more stagnation. There shall be no more limitation. Wherever you fell before, after this broadcast, you shall succeed. Wherever you were rejected, after now you shall be accepted. Wherever you were laughed at, after now you will be celebrated. Wherever you were forgotten, after now you will be remembered for good. Because the yoke is coming off thy neck. Because the yoke is coming off thy neck. Because the burden is taken off thy shoulder. Yes, shall you not bear the pains of yesterday. Yes, shall you not bear the pains of last night. Yes, shall you not remember the pains of yesteryears. Why? Because the burden is taken off your shoulder and the yoke is broken off your neck. If the Lord be a liar, then he cannot write the scripture. But if the word the Lord is saying in the scripture, in the book of Isaiah chapter 10 verses 27 is true, then the Lord is going to show up for you. After now, that sickness shall be broken. After now there shall be no more oxygen. After now there shall be nobody sick among us. After now every pandemic shall not come near you. After now you are exempted from whatever harms the world. Why? Because the Lord has promised you that he is going to take off the yoke from thy neck and he's going to take away the burden from your shoulder. Whom the Lord has set free. Who can engage the man that God has set free? Whom the Lord has released from bondage? Who can put the man back to bondage? Whom the Lord has set free from redemption? Who can put the man back where God has removed the man? Wherever you fell, that visa you were denied, that document that was canceled, that reputation that you're going on, that court case that is going on, by the power of the Almighty God, it is broken in the name of Jesus. It is broken in the name of Jesus. Every evil burden that the enemies have put on you, every evil burden that the evil ones brought upon you, and they said you can never be saved. They said wherever you go, the eyes of the Lord will not have mercy on you. They said wherever you go, there shall be no prophet that will see it. They said wherever you go, your case shall not be revealed. They said wherever you go, they did it and they laughed in their heart. And they said, ha 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 ha, we have done her wickedness. We have done him wickedness. Shame unto the devil and his associate. Because today the Lord is taking off their body. Today the Lord is taking off the yoke of thy neck. Today the Lord is removing every burden from your shoulder. So you are not limited to man's proposal. You are not limited to what anybody says. You are not limited to the stories of yesterday. It doesn't matter how many lives you killed yesterday. It doesn't matter how many abortions you did yesterday. It doesn't matter whether you believed yesterday. But right now and today, we are talking about the promises of the Lord. He says he is taking away the burden of thy neck. And he's breaking in every yoke of difficulties, it is broken in the name of Jesus. Yoke of dizziness, it is broken in the name of Jesus. Yoke of sickness, it is broken in the name of Jesus. Every evil yoke of the enemy. Today I came with the voice of the thunder. Today I came with the voice of an earthquake to announce to you that enough is enough. It doesn't matter how long you have stayed in that predicament. It doesn't matter how long you have stayed in that condition. It doesn't matter how many times you have prayed about that case. But today, every single sickness that was in your body, the Lord is taking it away in the name of Jesus. Every sickness from the crown of your head to the sole of your feet, however it got into your body, I am not interested. However the sickness got into your body, it is none of my business. All I want you to know is that the Lord is taking away the yoke from thy neck. What is the yoke you have been carrying? The yoke of delay. The yoke of limitation. The yoke of no fruitfulness. The yoke of disappointment. The yoke of promise and failure. The yoke of going forward but there is no way. The yoke of no promotion. The yoke of no joy in your life. The yoke of sadness. The yoke of many years and you do not have a spot to go. Today, right here, I see the Lord taking away the yoke from someone's neck. I see the Lord taking away the yoke from someone's neck. I see the Lord taking away the yoke from someone's neck. I see the Lord taking away the yoke from someone's neck. That yoke of evil. That evil chain of the enemy. That they chained you and they say you will never see better days. Whoever spoke in your life that you will not see better days. Today the yoke is broken. Today the spell is broken. Today the manipulation is broken. Today the manipulation is broken. Every year that the Kenke Wednesday, whatever spell the witches and the wizard cast on you, today it is broken. 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 Whoever swore and beat their souls and say you will mourn for the rest of your life. Whoever say you will not see better days. Whoever say you will cry and tears will not be anywhere in your eyes. Today, you shall cry no more. I see the Lord wiping the tears of so many. I see the Lord wiping the tears of so many. I see the Lord giving life back to so many. I see the Lord saying it is time for your breakthrough. I see the Lord saying it is time for your deliverance. I see the Lord saying it is time for your promotion. I see the Lord saying it is time for your marriage. I see the Lord saying it is time for you to be fruitful. I see the Lord saying it is time for you to get that document. I hear the Lord says it is time for you to come out of every captivity. Why? Just because the yoke is broken. The yoke must be broken. The yoke will be broken. The yoke of sickness must be broken. Oh, when I raise up my hands. Oh, yes. The yoke must be broken. Thy yoke must be broken. Thy yoke must be broken. Cause I raise up my hand now. Oh yes, thy yoke must be broken. Oh, the yoke of sickness must be broken. The yoke of barrenness must be broken. When I raise up my hands. Today as I raise up my hand to heaven. Every evil yoke in your life is broken in the name of Jesus. Who says you cannot make it? Who says you will not succeed? Who say you will not go places? Who say whatever you start, you will not complete? Who say you will start a journey and you will not end it? Who said you will be laughed at? Who said you will be mocked at? Who said this year will not end well for you? Today, the yoke is broken. Every pronouncement of the enemy, every wicked covenant of the enemy, every vow of the enemy, every oath of the enemy, today, their yoke is broken. Today, their yoke is broken. Today, thy yoke is broken and is taken off thy neck in the name of Jesus. Thy yoke is broken off thy neck in the name of Jesus. Thy yoke is broken off thy neck in the name of Jesus. That burden is rising off from your shoulder in the name of Jesus. Let me tell you guys something. It does not cost God a thing. It does not cost God a thing for him to cause situations to bow down for your sake. It does not cost God a thing for him to speak into that ugly situation. It does not cost God a thing for him to say enough is enough. It does not cost God a thing for him to say my daughter, my son, my child. Out of that situation, you have been in there for so long. It does not cost him a thing, but it takes you and I to make it happen immediately. We read in the book of Isaiah chapter 10 verses 27. It says, and on that day, and it shall come to pass in that day, it shall come to pass in that day. Which day? Personalize it and say, and it shall come to pass today. And it shall come to pass right now. And it shall come to pass in this season. I don't know how many of you have given God a time frame. Have you ever sat down and you told the Lord and said something to God? And say, Father, in this year, birthday, this year of my birthday, I am not asking you for anything. It is always on your birthday that you place a demand, right? On your birthday, you must make a wish. On your birthday, you must make a wish. Unless you are not a living being. Everybody has a need that must be met on their birthday. Everybody has an expectation in their heart on their birthday. Like last year's birthday. Everybody knew that I had an expectation. I said to God, I wanted an LV handbag. An LV handbag cost over $3,500. I said to God, I want an LV handbag. I said to God, this is what I wanted. That was my expectation. And it was met. God made it happen. A gift of $3,500. Calculate that in Naira. That is over 1.something million. Handbag. What is your need? Everybody has a need that must be met. So can you not tell God on your special day, Father, on this birthday of mine in this year, no matter what it will cost you to settle me, settle me. Father, on my birthday this year, before this year ends, I just want you to do one thing for me. Even if it will cost heaven for me to be promoted, let my promotion come forth. Ha! If the Lord can say that we are taking away the yoke of thy neck, who is the man to come and put back the yoke on your neck? He says he has taken the burden off your shoulder. Why did he say he has taken the burden off your shoulder? Because he knows that we have so many burdens. He says, I have taken it off thy shoulder. On that day, Can you not personalize it and said, and it says, and the yoke shall be destroyed. And the yoke shall be destroyed. Begin to tell the Lord. Begin to tell the Lord, Father, let the yoke be destroyed today. Let today be the day you are going to destroy that yoke for me. That yoke of unhappiness. That yoke of uncertainty. That yoke of no happiness. That yoke of disappointment. That yoke of failure. That yoke of stagnation. That yoke of not going forward. Some of you, instead of going forward, you're going backward. Some of you, instead of going forward in life, you're going backwards. People are counting your years backwards. People are counting your days backward. People are counting your marriage backward. It should be counted forward. But why are they counting it backward? Because of the evil handwriting. Because of the evil seal. Because of the evil pronouncement. And then your life begins to experience stagnation. And then you are crying from morning till night. And then you do not have comfort. Even when people are comforting you, you cannot be comforted because your sorrows are too much. He begins to sound like the woman in the Bible. When they said that she was drunk, she said, no, I am not drunk. I have not drunk no single thing. But it's because the Lord has made me glad. It's because my heart is red. That is why I am serving God. And it seems as though I am mad. And it seems as though I do not know myself. But I am not drunk in alcohol. Maybe I am drunk in the goodness of the Lord. Maybe I am drunk with the good things that God has done. But I am not drunk in alcohol. Sometimes you need to come out of your comfort zone and make yourself uncomfortable for the devil. Sometimes you need to pray yourself out of that ugly situation. Sometimes you need to untie yourself. Sometimes you need to be free. Sometimes you need a garment that you would worship. Sometimes you need a space to worship. Sometimes you need an altar you would worship. Worship until you go crazy in your worship. Worship until you feel that something has left you. Worship until you feel that God has answered you. You will not stop. You said, no, today I came to encounter you. I am not going to leave you except you bless me. I am not going to let you go. I am not going to let you go unless you fulfill your promise. This is what you're saying in the book of Isaiah. The Bible made me to understand, it says, all men be liar, for God is not a man that he should lie. Hold God unto his word. Hold God unto his promise. He is faithful and he is righteous to keep all the words that came out of his name. He says he honor his words even more than his name. Tell the Lord that you said in your word that you will take away every yoke from my neck and you will take away every burden from my shoulder. Where is my neck still heavy with burden? Where is my shoulder still heavy with burdens? When am I carrying the yoke of sorrow? When am I carrying the yoke of limitation? When am I carrying the yoke of delay? When am I carrying the yoke of failure? When am I carrying the yoke of no tomorrow? When am I carrying the yoke of no certainty? When am I carrying the yoke of not moving forward? Where is my life like super glue? When am I glued to a position? Where am I tied down to a season? I am not a tree. Therefore, I'm expected to move according to season, according to time, according to hour, according to period. My life is not limited. My life is not stagnant. I can move. I should move. I should change. I should dominate. You gotta tell the Lord, I got to dominate. I got to make an impact. I got to change my life. I got to move from this place of sorrow to a place where I can be joyful. I need to move to a place of burden, to a place where I can sing glory. I need to move from a place of tears to a place where I shall laugh forever. It is God's promises for you. Why is the yoke standing? Some of us, the yoke has been there. Right from when we were born until now, the yoke is there. Right from when we were children till now that we are married, the yoke is there. Right from when we were in school till now that we have graduated, the yoke is there. Right from when we were born again till now that we have lost our faith, the yoke is there. When will the yoke be taken off thy neck? When will the yoke be taken off thy neck? When will your burden be taken off your shoulder? Challenge yourself. Challenge your condition. Challenge your Father in heaven. And tell him, Father, enough is enough. I came to cry out aloud. I came to shout to you. I came to pray unto you. Because I know that you hear me. You say your ears are not shortened. That you cannot hear my prayer. Neither are your eyes shortened. That you cannot see my situation. Neither are your hands shortened. That you cannot touch my situation. And you cannot change my story. But it's because I have been silent. But it's because I have not been praying. But it is because I have not asked. It is because I do not believe. It is because I do not have faith. That is why it seems as if my story is not going to change. That is why it seems as if my story is not going to end. That is why it seems as if my story is not going to have a change. Oh Lord, today I acknowledge in your word that you can take away the yoke of my neck and you can take the burden off my shoulder. Father, because I acknowledge this, come and take the yoke off my neck. Come and take the yoke off my soul. Come and take the yoke off my family. Come and take the yoke off my job. Come and take the yoke off my marriage. Come and take the yoke off my success. Come and take the yoke off my situation. Father, you said in your word that you would take away the burden from my shoulder. You said there shall be no burden on my shoulder. Therefore, why is me? Am I still carrying the burden? What did the Bible say? In Isaiah chapter 10, verses 27, the yoke shall be broken from thy neck, and the burden shall be taken from thy shoulder. So what is the burden? The burden of stagnation, the burden of sickness, the burden of sorrow, the burden of no failure. It is still standing there. Probably the burden stood in your mother's side. The burden stood from your father's side. The burden stood in your generation. The burden stood in your village. The burden stood in your village. Now it has come to your marriage. It is coming to your business. It is coming to your health. And the burden is still there. And you are comfortable with this burden. You say, well, God understands. Oh, yes, he does understand. Yeah, God really understands. He understands, trust me. Even when you are sleeping, God understands. But sometimes you need to be aggressive in your spirit. Sometimes you need to be violent because the enemies of your life, they are not sleeping. Sometimes you need to put your faith to work and say, Lord, I am standing on the scripture. I am not standing on my own covenant, but I'm standing on the promises of God. I am standing on the word of God that says in the book of Isaiah chapter 10 that on that day, I am personalizing it. This day, right now, the burden shall be taken off my neck. The burden shall be taken off my shoulder. I don't care what yoke it is. Yoke of not marrying. Yoke of not progressing. Yoke of no deliverance. Yoke of no fruitfulness. The yoke is still there. It has been hanging on your mother's neck. It has been hanging on your father's neck. It has been hanging on your sibling. You don't care to break the yoke. Today, the yoke must be broken by fire in the name of Jesus. The Bible makes me to understand. It says, by the power of the anointing. By the power that is in the anointing, the yoke must be broken. By the power that is in the anointing, ha, child of God, hear me, the yoke must be broken. I went to visit my spiritual father one day. I went to visit my spiritual father one day in person of Reverend I. Intia. I went to visit him in his office. And I walked in and we began to talk. And he was just staring at me and he was just laughing. He was guessing at me and he was laughing. And I was talking because I'm so interesting. Like when you see me talk, I'm going to talk with demonstrating and laughing and making a moment count. I'm the type that always make the moment count. And I said to him, Daddy, there is something about me. He says, what is it? I said, people always say this, people always say that. He says, and so what? I said, Daddy, sometimes people can't understand me. He said, yes. That's the point. They shouldn't understand you. Why do they need to understand you? He says, why do they need to understand you? I don't get it. And I looked at him and I was like, wow, really? They don't need to understand me? He said, yeah. So long as you understand yourself, so long as you know what you're doing, and so long as God understands you, that's all that matters. Not people. Don't worry your head, my dear. Ayore, about people. You know, people will tell you this bondage has been there in the family. People will tell you in this family, every first child does not marry. In this family, every first child does not stay in marriage. In this family, the first son is not progressive. No, it is not your portion. That was in their time. It does not even matter the prophecy of a prophet who said it shall not happen. Today, the Lord is breaking the yoke of thy neck. Every evil yoke that was on your neck, today I release that yoke in the name of Jesus. Every evil yoke that was placed on your neck, today I remove that embargo in the name of Jesus. Every burden that was rested on your shoulder, today they are taken off from you. In the mighty name of Jesus, your life shall never be the same. Your marriage can never be the same. Your relationship can never be the same. Your ministry can never be the same. Your school can never be the same. Everything in this life that is not according to God's plan can never be the same. Even in this period of the pandemic, you shall hear, you shall see, you shall perceive, but it shall not come near your dwelling place. Why? Because the yoke is taken off thy neck and the burden is taking off thy shoulder in the mighty name of Jesus. 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 I said it is taken away in the mighty name of Jesus. Okay, now it is time to bless the anointing. Quickly get your anointing. Get your anointing. Get your anointing. When you have your bottle of anointing oil, just go ahead and type, I have my anointing oil ready. We are coming to break the yoke. We are coming to break every limitation of the enemy. We are coming to break every burden that was resting on your shoulder. As you get the anointing oil, just type, I gave my anointing. You know, child of God, the Bible makes us to understand that right from the days of John the Baptist, the kingdom of God suffered violence, and that the violent take it by force. Sometimes you need to be aggressive. Sometimes you need to take back what the enemies have stolen from you. There is no gentleman, there is no gentlewoman in the kingdom of God. So if you know how the devil works day and night to make sure that you do not smile, you will never spare the devil. I was singing a song the other day. I said, shout hallelujah, when yah, when yah. Oh, don't let the devils put you down, when the old man comes your way. Oh, just lift your hands and praise the Lord. Shout hallelujah, anyhow, just anyhow. You need to shout your hallelujah anyhow, any way, every way. Don't let the devil, the idiot, the mumushos, the nonsensical, the idiotic of a thing called the devil. Do you not know that the devil is a loser? Do you not know that the devil is a bastard? Do you not know that the devil is fatherless? Do you not know that the devil is an... In fact, I don't know what name to use in describing the devil. He's a smelling animal. He's got no power. Even hellfire that is possessing is not his. Hellfire belongs to God. He only threw the devil there because that's where he rightfully belongs. Do you know that the devil was called the morning star? Do you know that the devil had the most beautiful voice in heaven singing to God? But because he was stupid, because he was an idiot, because he was greedy, he decided to compare himself to God. And he was dethroned from the beginning of the world. And today you are coming to bow for a nonsensical, a mumushos, a useless, powerless, it smelling fool of a devil. I always say, if I see the devil one in one, the devil can't stand me. Because I am so going to reduce him to what he has no idea about. Whoever is giving preference, whoever is giving glory, whoever is giving meaning to the devil is meaningless. He's an idiot. An idiotic element. That's what the devil is. He smells. He's a fool. So why would you want to deal with someone like that? He's powerless. Just go ahead and type, I have my anointing oil ready when you have it ready. So far, I am seeing just two people who has their oil ready. So far, I am seeing two people have their oil ready. Today was powerful. I think today is the last day, and it is actually the fastest of all the video. Every other day, we were doing two hours. But I think today is going to be less than 2 hours. That is why, because I came with a flaming fire. Because I came with a voice of thunder. Today I came with a snatching voice from the Most High God. And I was releasing the word with fire. My God, my God, my God, my God. Rikalabaseki lebo shotaya. Makushata ribasankaya. Rikababaseke lebo setaya. Makashata labasataya. Rekelibasantaya. Hida maseke. Rama. If you have missed this video from the beginning, go and watch it from the beginning, because you don't want to miss this video. It was too powerful. This is the one they call corrosive. It was corrosive. I can feel sweat all over my body. Like, I could feel fire coming from my back. As I was talking, I could feel fire of the Holy Ghost coming on me so hard. As I was preaching, I could feel fire from the Most High upon me. At the time, I went crazy. How many people saw it? My God. I didn't know myself for like 20 minutes. I was just on it. And the Lord is like, release it the way I'm sending you. Because my children must be set free. My children must be released from captivity. My children must be set loose from wherever they were bound. Enough is enough. I have my anointing oil ready. Just go ahead and type. I have it ready. I have it ready. I have it ready. I have it ready. I see Aisha has her anointing oil ready. I see Cynthia has her anointing oil ready. I see Adama has her anointing oil ready. Somebody says it was different dimension. You have not seen anything if you did not start from the beginning. Go back. If I don't have, what can I use? Okay, Alina, you can use water. You can replace the anointing oil with water. Use water. If you don't have your anointing oil, you can pick up water. Just pick up water in a glass, in a cup, in a bottle. It's the same thing. We are going to consecrate it to the blood of Jesus. So whatever you have, if you don't have the anointing oil, just have your water. If you don't have the anointing oil, have your water. And before I bless this anointing oil, if you are on this broadcast and you did not share, don't leave me to tell you to share and have your blessing. I have always told you people something. I say with me, it is anointing. It is the anointing that makes the difference. And in order for the anointing to make the difference, you must connect and receive. In order for the anointing to make the difference in your life, you need to connect to receive. Without you connecting, you cannot receive. So most times, don't even wait for me to remind you and say, brother, sister, go and share. If you don't bless someone with the word of God, how will you be blessed? Before we started the broadcast, somebody came in from Jamaica and said, Mommy, thank you for praying for a lady yesterday. And she mentioned the lady's name, Ruby. Thank you for praying for Ruby yesterday during the Holy Anointing service. Who knows, who remembers that lady? She just came on, the Holy Spirit asked me to pray for her, and I said, okay. I stopped and I prayed for her. And she said she was down with BP, that her BP is so high. And that she's giving God an offering of $50. And I went ahead and I prayed for her. You're going to hear this testimony soon. We are not playing here. If you have been going to elsewhere and you have been playing, I have told you when you come on my broadcast, if you're my boyfriend, just leave it outside. If you're my father, leave it outside. If you're my sister, leave it outside. My mother, whatever you are to me, however you know me, when I am on the live broadcast, I am a different person. I am not that Kate that you know. I am the first lady of God. When you see me here, I take charge. I take preeminence of every situation. I swallow the premises and the environment. Whatever I declare of my father, that's what he would do. And even more. The one I have seen with my eyes, the one I have blessed with my mouth, that is how it's going to happen. All you need is your faith. I wish it was easy to receive for people. There are so many people I would have received for. Sometimes I wish it is easy for me to receive for people because I am a woman of faith. For me, my faith is crazy. I have a crazy faith. That is why it is not hard for the impossibilities to become possible for me, because my faith is crazy. I believe that Jesus can cause the day not to come tonight for my sake. I believe that the day can remain like this all day just for God to cause something to happen. I believe that the time can slow down in seconds, in minutes, just so that I can get there. I was driving a car the other day and I was going to the registry. And I looked at the time and it was 10 minutes to 4. And the registry is going to close by 4. And my house is 15 minutes drive away from where I'm going. And I look at the time and I refuse to be late. I said to myself, I cannot be late. Even if I am the last person that they will attend to at the registry and they will shut the door, so shall it be done unto me. But I am not going to go back. I am putting my faith to work. And I am telling God, Father, you know that if I don't get my car registered today, I am not going to do it any other day. Father, for your name's sake, do it for me. And I saw that the time delayed. The seconds were counting so slow. The minutes were counting so slow. When I typed in the address on my GPS so that the GPS can give me the fastest route, the GPS showed me 18 minutes. And I'm having 10 minutes in front of me to go to the registry. And the GPS is showing me 18 minutes. But I refuse to listen to the GPS. I refuse to listen to the time showing on the GPS. I say, it is God that beats time. It is God that breaks protocol. Father, let the way be clear for your daughter. I am coming as your first lady. Blow the siren and let the way be clear for me. And I got in my car. I started the car. I drove like, in fact, I don't know if I was observing the school zone. I don't know if I was observing the red lights. All I know is that I drove successfully and I got to the registry. And I entered the registry. As soon as I entered the registry, they bolted the door. Right at the registry, I knelt down and I said, Father, you are worthy. And everybody was just looking at me like they cannot understand. My God. Some of you would have gone back. Some of you would have gone back. Have you ever prayed and told God to circumcise the heart of somebody for them not to have peace? All they think about is you. Have you ever prayed for the Lord to collect something from somebody for you by his will? Have you ever told the Lord, Father, I have suffered so much in my family, in my lineage. I want you to use me to break records. How are you praying? How are you praying? For those of you who don't know how to pray, you gotta follow my page. I don't know how to pray. Follow my page. Every Monday we come up with prayer. Every Monday we come up with prayer points. There is no single day I don't post prayer points, Bible passage on my page. That is what I was called for. You look up for my page. Any day you don't see me post something on my page, look for me. There is a problem. Any day you wake up, mommy did not make post. From the beginning of that day to the end of that day, look for me, there is something wrong. It has never happened. For the past year since I gave my life to Christ, it has never happened. You would see something. Even when I'm posting pictures, make sure you're reading between the lines. You will be motivated. Your life will be transformed. That is what I am. The Lord says he has kept me like water to quench the thirst of many. He says, I have kept you like food in the world that many will eat and find satisfaction. He says, I have sent you to go and be truthful to me because there are so many that are not honest. That is why I called you. That is why I chose you, because I know you're going to go for me. And for as many that are thirsty and they come to me, I don't know if their thirst has not been quenched. For as many that follows me, no matter how broken you were in your spirit, when you follow me, you will be uplifted. If you follow my page every day, anytime you are broken in your spirit, go to my page, you'll be uplifted. And I'm telling you what God said. I'm not telling you what I know. I am not telling you what I'm not sure of. I'm telling you what God said. So everything you see me writing, everything you see me posting, it's not because I want to post them. It's not because I just want to do them. It is directed by the Holy Spirit. And if the Lord does not speak, I do not speak. So go and see for yourself. Just visit the page and see how your life is going to be transformed. Some people just come to the page. They have never seen me before. But they go and sleep and then they have an encounter with me. It is God that is doing this thing. He said, many are called, but few are chosen. So I am the few ones that have been chosen. It is not by my making. It is not by my power. It is not by my might. He said, whoever I want to show mercy, I will show mercy. Whoever I want to be compassionate to, I will be compassionate to. He says he is a jealous God. So you don't need to blame some people when they are so favorable by God, when they are God's favorites. You just need to take it the way it is. Even the parents, they have their favorite child. Even friends, they have favorite friends. Even pastors, it is like that. But you need to do something to win the mind of the Lord. You're not just going to lie down and sleep and win the mind of the Lord. No. You're not just going to lie down and sleep and win the mind of your pastor. No. All these things have principles, so you must follow them. If your oil is ready, I said, type, my oil is ready. I see 77 people, but I don't see my oil is ready at all. Maybe people are writing and I am not seeing. Because I am going to be praying. Today is the last day. Today is the day 3 of 3. Today is the last day. And it was so powerful. For those of you that are just coming in right now, you have missed like how many? Let me see how many. You have missed like an hour, 37 minutes. If you're just coming into this video, you have missed an hour, 37 minutes. So go and watch this video from the beginning. It is going to really help your life. Today I said I was not going to spend up to 2 hours. And the Holy Spirit honored me. I said I was not going to spend up to 2 hours. The Holy Spirit honored me. May God bless me in the mighty name of Jesus. May God bless you in the mighty name of Jesus. May God bless you in the mighty name of Jesus. Angela Anyanwu. Angela Anyanwu. Angela Anyanwu. Angela Anyanwu. I see celebration coming for you, Angela. I see celebration coming for you, Angela. Angela Anyanwu. I see celebration that is coming for you. Angela Anyanwu. Write today's date. I see celebration that is coming for you. I see a very big celebration that is coming for you, Angela. Angela Anyanwu, I see a very big celebration that is coming for you. I see a big celebration that is coming for you. I see a big celebration that is coming for you. You see, while it is always good for you to type when you are asked to type, because then you can just be visited. Then you have just been visited. Then you have just been visited. Halina, today you have to pray for me. Since 2018, I followed you, but you have never prayed for me. Halina, call me. Halina, call me. I don't know why I am seeing this garment covering you. Halina, if you can call me right now before I pray for the anointing. If you can call me on video call, Halina, call me. I see this garment that is covering you. I see this veil that is thrown. You know when a lady is getting married, they cover you with a veil, right? When they open the veil before they see your face. That is how she is covered. Her face is covered like that. A short veil like that, covering her. Covering her. And the color is black. You are not supposed to be covering a black veil. You are not supposed to be covering a black veil. If you're not even celebrating, if you're not even expecting marriage, if you're not celebrating marriage, if you're not expecting marriage, a veil should not be covering your face. When a veil covers your face, nobody can see your real face. It means that there is something that is covering you. Every evil veil that is covering you, today I uncover that veil in the name of Jesus. I uncover that veil in the name of Jesus. I uncover that veil in the name of Jesus. That evil veil that the enemies have covered you so that your star will not show, so that your destiny will not show. I uncover you with that veil in the name of Jesus. I uncover that veil from your face in the name of Jesus. I uncover you with that veil in the name of Jesus. And I pray today for you that every other evil veil, the ones that the eyes of the physical have not seen, today as I see it in the realms of the spirit, I break and I tear them in the name of God the Father. I tear that evil veil in the name of God the Son. And I tear that veil in the name of the Holy Spirit. From today henceforth, your glory, your star, your beauty, whatever God created you to be, will come to pass this day speedily in the mighty name of Jesus. And so shall it be in Jesus' mighty name. And so shall it be in Jesus' mighty name. And so shall it be in Jesus' mighty name. Look at how people miss. There is no button. She said there is no button. May the Lord help her in Jesus' name. She says there is no button. I prayed for you anyways. I already prayed for you. Because I know that sometimes we are confused. I said, call me on Facebook Messenger video call. Not on the live broadcast. Because Facebook do no longer have call button. So just call on Facebook Messenger. I have my oil ready. I have my oil ready. So many people are going to be set free. So many of you are going to have dreams tonight. So many of you are going to see yourself in a place that you could not even imagine or understand. But when you wake up in the morning, for those of you who have not been remembering your dream, after blessing this anointing oil and you partake of it, you are going to have a dream and you are going to see yourself in a strange place. You're going to see yourself in strange doing, in strange gatherings. But by the time you come out of it, that is the end. The Lord has delivered you. He has taken the yoke off thy neck. He has taken the burden off thy shoulder. Your life can never remain the same. Your marriage can never remain the same. Your career can never remain the same. Your promotions will never remain the same. Your jobs can never be the same. Your children can never be the same. Your ministry can never be the same. Everything that was tormenting you is not going to be the same anymore. After now, in the mighty name of Jesus, let us pray. Father, in the mighty name of Jesus, King of glory, Lord Almighty, Jehovah El Shaddai, I thank you for a time and for a season like this. I worship you because you're God all by yourself. You said in your scripture, is there anything that I cannot do? And the answer is no, Lord, there is nothing that you cannot do. You are the God that divided the Red Sea. You are the God that made a way out of wilderness. You are the God that gave Sarah and Job a testimony. You are that same God that has showed up in for us. You are my God of 4 days comma. You are my covenant keeping God. I call you my ocean divider because you have proven yourself in diverse ways. Father, today we thank you for a successful 3 days of this program. We thank you for the successful completion of our 3 days anointing oil service. Father, we know that you are going to do mightily for your children in the name of Jesus. Father, we know that you're going to make dry bones to rise again in the name of Jesus. Father, we know that you're going to make every broken heart to be mended in the name of Jesus. Father, we know that you're going to restore lives again in the name of Jesus. Father, we know that you're going to raise the dead and you're going to raise the sick, Lord. Father, in this pandemic that has taken over the world, we know you are going to be our protection. Father, we know you are going to be a shield that covers us in our going out, in our coming in. Father, we know that whatever affects the world is not permitted to come near us. Father, today you took us to the book of Isaiah, chapter 10, verses 27. And you did not say next week. You did not say next year. You did not say next month. You said by this time, this day. And Lord, we personalize it to right now. You said this shall also pass away. That it shall come to pass, Lord. that the yoke shall be taken off our neck and every burden shall be taken off our shoulder. Father, today your children have come to see you, not to see me. Every evil yoke that was placed on their neck, let it be broken in the name of Jesus. Every evil yoke in their marriages, Lord, let it be broken in the name of Jesus. Every evil yoke in their relationship, let it be broken in the name of Jesus. Every evil yoke in their endeavors, Lord, let it be broken in the name of Jesus. Father, you said you would take away the burdens of our shoulders. Some of us, we have been carrying burdens right from when we were children till this day. Some of us, we have been carrying the burdens of families. Some of us, we are carrying the burdens of marriage. Some of us, we are carrying the burdens of ministry. Some of us, we are carrying the burdens of witches and wizards. And some of us, we are carrying the burdens of principalities and powers in high places. Some of us, the enemies have held us in captivity. They have held us hostage. They have held us bound. Father, by the power that is in the anointing, let the anointing break every yoke. Let the anointing take away every burden. In the mighty name of Jesus, Father, you are the God that changes not. You are the first and the last, Lord. You are the beginning and the end, Lord. Today is the end of this program. Father, let there be influx of testimonies. Let there be influx of signs and wonders. Let there be influx of healing. Let there be influx of promotion. Let there be influx of pregnancies. Let there be influx of marriages. Let there be influx of promotions. Let there be influx of divine healing. Let there be influx of divine promotions. In any way or the other that your children have come with a request in their hearts, rather for them that are down, Father, be the comforter to them. For they that are broken, Father, mend every broken heart. In the mighty name of Jesus. In the mighty name of Jesus. In the mighty name of Jesus. There is power almighty in the blood. There is power mighty in the name of Jesus Christ. There is power mighty in the anointing. Today, Lord Jesus, this is no longer an anointing that we bought from the store. This is no longer an anointing that we bought from the supermarket. This is no longer an anointing that we took from our homes, Lord. This is now consecrated to become the blood of Jesus. I hereby consecrate the oil in your hands to become the blood of Jesus. The blood of Jesus that speaketh better things than the blood of Abel. The blood of Jesus that speaketh every other thing than the blood of human. If the blood of human can speak, how much more the blood of Jesus. Today, right, take this anointing oil and I put it on the one that came out of your rib on the cross of Calvary. Father, by your sins we were cleansed. Father, by your stripes we were healed. Father, for your suffering and the bruise you took on the cross of Calvary, there is none permitted to go down anymore in our lives. Every evil and writing that was written, every spoken word from the ordinances that our life cannot go forward, by the power that is in the blood of Jesus today, right now, Lord. Father, wash us from the crown of our head to the sole of our feet. Father, cleanse us and make us purify in the name of Jesus. Father, redeem us by the power that is in the anointing. Father, make us ready and acceptable before you, Lord. Do not allow the devil to put a demarcation between our prayer. Do not allow sin to stand as a barrier between our prayer. Father, we plead your mercy. We plead your blood on the cross of Calvary. Let your precious blood redeem us. Let your precious blood uplift us. Let your precious blood yield us. Father, in the name of Jesus, you said in the scripture that we should anoint ourselves. We should bathe the oil and we should wear our best clothes. clothes. Father, as we anoint ourselves today, we are anointed for greater glory. We are anointed for greater honor. We are anointed for signs and wonders. We are anointed to walk in redemption of the Lord. We are anointed to move our salvation from where it is to where you want us to be. As we anoint ourselves, Lord, let our faith be uplifted. In the mighty name of Jesus, every sickness, every barrier, every difficulties, every stagnation, every disappointment, by the power of the anointing, the yoke is taken off our necks. In the name of Jesus, by the power of the anointing, the burden is taken off our shoulders. In the mighty name of Jesus. Father, today we are more than 3,000. Today we are more than 2,000. Maybe we are more than 4,000. For as many that will watch this video, Father, let your blood redeem them. Let your blood redeem them. Let your blood redeem them. In the mighty name of Jesus, we use ourselves as a point of contact for our family, friends, and loved ones. Father, whatever you do for one, you do it for all. Father, as you touch our lives today, touch our family, touch our children, touch our ministry, sons and daughters all over the world, people that call upon you in spirit and in truth, let the anointing be a sign of freedom. Let the anointing be a sign of freedom. Let there be a release in the realms of the spirit right now. I see a supernatural shift in the realms of the spirit. I see settlement for so many. I see upliftment for so many. I see a turnaround for so many. I see a brand new story for so many. I see a brand new chase for so many. I see you putting the garments of honor on so many. Father, may it not be long. Father, may it not linger. Father, may it not be delayed. In a time that is closer than we think, right now, right here, Lord, let your testimonies be released in the mighty name of Jesus. Let your testimonies be released in the mighty name of Jesus. Let your testimonies be released in the mighty name of Jesus. Thank you, King of Glory, Lord Almighty. Thank you, Jehovah Yahweh. Thank you, my unchangeable changer. Thank you, my story changer. We know that you have done exceedingly abundantly, more than we could ever ask of you or imagine. And in days to come, Lord, we will come and return the glory to your name. And let the shame be unto the devil and his associate forever. Thank you for the blessings. Thank you for the testimonies. Thank you for everything that you have done. May your wonderful name, may all glory, honor, adoration, which no man on earth, the president, senate, commissioners, ministers, everything they are looking for in this life they cannot find, may it be ascribed unto you alone, in the mighty name of Jesus. Father, all that we have to say is thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Jesus, because you have done so good, marvelous, beautiful. Thank you for changing our lives. Thank you for changing our story. Thank you for making our lives so beautiful and colorful. Today, as the blood comes into us, let the blood change our story forever. Today, as we drink of your blood, as we shower your blood, as we anoint ourselves with your blood, Father, we are anointed for greater glory. And so shall it be. And it is permanent. And it is done. In the mighty name of Jesus, we pray. Amen and amen. Thank you, Jesus. You can go ahead and drink. And then you anoint yourself. You can go ahead and drink. And also anoint yourself. You have fortified yourself. In this season, in this pandemic, whatever the enemy is doing, he shall not see you. Whatever the enemy is doing, I say, it shall not do what? Shall not see you. Remove your hair, pour it. Don't pour it on your wig, your scalp. Rub it. Make it your... You can even use it and fry egg. You can use your anointing and fry egg. Fry plantain. Cook rice. Make salad. Just eat. There is power mighty in the blood. Oh, there is power mighty in the blood. There is power mighty in the blood of Jesus Christ. There is power mighty in the power in the blood. There is power mighty in the blood. Power in the blood. There is power mighty in the blood. There is power mighty in the blood of Jesus Christ. There is power mighty in power in the blood. There is power mighty in working mighty power. There is power mighty in the blood, in the blood. There is power mighty in the blood of Jesus Christ. There is power mighty in the blood. Oh, I just want to say, Baba, oh, we share. I just want to say, Baba, oh, we share. We just want to say thank you. We just want to say, Baba, oh, we share. Oh, we just want to say, Baba, oh, we share. For the life you gave to us, we've come to say thank you. For the miracle you gave to us, we have come to say thank you. Daddy, for your son, Jesus Christ, who died just for our sake. Now we just want to say, Baba, oh, we share. Oh, we just want to say, Baba, oh, we share. Can you just say thank you? You just want to say, Baba, oh, we share. We just want to say, Daddy, oh, we share. Oh, we just want to say, Baba, oh, we share. We just want to say, Baba, oh, we share. Thank you. I just want to say, Daddy, oh, we share. I just want to say, Daddy, oh, we share. It is so wonderful to thank God. It is so marvelous. What the Lord has done for me, I cannot tell it all. What the Lord has done for me, I say, I cannot tell it all. What the Lord has done for me, I cannot share it all. It's wonderful, it's marvelous. His mercies endure it forever. Somebody just go ahead and worship the Lord. Just tell the Lord thank you. From day one to day two to day three, God is faithful. God is wonderful. God is gracious. He has read with us. He has stood by us. He has abided with us. We went out. We came back. Sunday, we started the water blessing service. We did the water blessing service on Sunday. We did on Monday. We did on Tuesday. The Lord was faithful. And on Wednesday, we had our Holy Communion service. As if that was not enough. On Thursday, we started the anointing service. And today, we started on Thursday. We did it successfully. We did it on Friday. Today is Saturday. And we have successfully ended today. Is our God not marvelous? Is our God not great? Is our God not, oh, I don't know what word to use. Sometimes God is so wonderful. Sometimes he's the God that knows it all. He loves me. I cannot say why. He loves me. I cannot say why. On Calvary tree, Jesus suffers such loss. He loves me. I cannot say why. Maybe you can say why the Lord loves you. Maybe you have a reason why God loves you. As for me, I don't have a reason why God loves me. I don't know why God loves me, but I know that he loves me that I cannot say why. If somebody asks me, First Lady, why are you God's favorite? Why are you the apple of God's eye? Why is it that the Lord honors you? I cannot say. All the way to Calvary, he went for me. He went for you. And today, despite the pandemic, some of us, we are still working. Some of us, we are still going out. Some of us, we are still gathering. Some of us, we are still going to church. But the Lord has preserved and kept us. Some of us, we are still being disobedient. Even as they have warned us to stay off social gathering. Even as they have warned us to stay in and stay safe. We are still being disobedient. We are still going to social gatherings. We are not even minding the whatever is being said on news. People of God, please, heaven help those who help themselves. As God helps you, as we pray for the Lord to protect you, please protect yourself. Stay in and stay safe. Avoid social gatherings for now. You can show love to your loved ones on the phone. Request a video call to people that you missed so that you can see them. You can even sleep with them all night in different country, on different bed. You can watch movie together on the video call. Just stay safe. Obedience is better than sacrifice. The people that are dying, it is not because God does not love them. The people that are dying, it is not because it is their carelessness. No. No. You are being protected and kept by God's mercy. God's mercy kept me, so I wouldn't let go. How many of you know? I almost gave up. I felt like I couldn't take life anymore. My problems really held me. Depression came and found me. He held me, so I wouldn't let go. God's mercy kept me, so I wouldn't let go. Now I'm alive today because you kept me. I'm alive today only because of his grace. He kept me. God kept me. He kept me, so I wouldn't let go. You know, when I see people dying like this, I go back 3 years back to my life story. And I begin to ask the Lord some questions. I say, why did you not take my life in that 4 days of coma? Why did you not seize my life in the 4 days of coma? Why did you not allow me to die when I was on that hospital bed? Why did you not allow my life to be seized when I was on that hospital bed with all the life support, the monitors and the life, everything was being put to me? Lord, why did you not take my life? Ha! Take my life. Lord, do whatever pleases you. Take my life. And do whatever pleases you. Take my life. Do whatever pleases you. You are the Alpha, you are the Omega. Take my life. Lord, take my life. Just do what I see to please you, Lord. Take my life. And do whatever pleases you. take my life and do whatever pleases you. You are the Alpha, you are the Omega, take my life. Lord, I don't want to be me. I want to live for you forever, take my life and do just as it pleases you. Take my life, do whatever pleases you, Lord. You are the Alpha, you are the Omega, take my life. I don't want to live for myself. Lord, just do whatever pleases you with me. Take my life and do whatever pleases you. Just take my life, Jesus, and do whatever pleases you. You are my Alpha, you are my Omega, take my life. Ah, when I am down, take my life. Lord, do whatever pleases you with it. Take my life and do whatever pleases you. Take my life, Lord, and do whatever pleases you with it. You are the Alpha, you are the Omega, take my life. What does this remind some of us? Some of you remember when we went to Maryland, the first program we had in New Jersey. And I got into the spirit. And I told the Lord to take my life and do whatever pleases him. I said to God, take my life. Whatever you want to do with my life, do it. I don't care. I don't need my life. My life is in your hands. Lord, have your way. Take my life and do whatever pleases you. We finished a conference in April. May, I came back to Canada and I worked. No, I came back in May. June. The Lord says, you say I should take your life. You say I should do what pleases me with your life. Bam, my job was gone in June. I came on the live broadcast and I began to cry. I said I was laid off for no reason. And I was given a check. They paid me off. And I began to ask the Lord, I said, what do I do with this money? He says, go and pay rent for the church. You told me to take your life and do whatever pleases me. So this is what pleases me. I want you to stop that work. And I want you to work for me. I don't want you to work for man again. I want you to work for me. I need more of your time. You are not committed to me. And you guys knew that I was struggling then, right? I was always struggling. I almost canceled a program in Maryland because of what? Job. I said, I cannot. I don't have time to come for the program in Maryland. I'm working. The Lord took away the job. Some people remember, first conference at New Jersey. That was the very first conference. And then he took my job. He said, look at you. You said I should do whatever pleases me. How many of you have told God, Father, take my life and do as it pleases you? How many people have ever gotten to the condition where they told God, Father, I don't want to live for myself. I want to live for you. I want to know you more. The more I know you, the more I want to know you, Jesus. More of you, Lord, I want more of you. Spirit, more of you. Have you ever sat down and told the Lord, Father, I want more of you. I want you to open my ears of understanding. I want you to open my spiritual eyes that I can see. I want you to open my tongue that I can speak of your good news. How many of you have ever asked God for the gift of the Holy Spirit? I remember those days I would just come online. And the Lord says, today there are five people that are going to receive the gift of the Holy Spirit. And I said, I don't know who the five people are. But the Lord is telling me that there are five people on this live broadcast. Father, in the mighty name of Jesus, I pray for Keisha Smith. Let a new job locate her. Your will, God. Yes, I lost my job 2 weeks ago. Father, let a new job locate this one in the mighty name of Jesus. Keisha Smith, may the Lord release a new job unto you. I am seeing you working in less than 3 months. Receive it in the name of Jesus. Keisha Smith, just put your hand on the chest and say to the Lord, Father, if you release this job that you're speaking about in this atmosphere in 3 months for me, I shall come back to testify. And if you're honest from your heart that you would return with a testimony, I release that job for you right now, speedily, in the name of Jesus. Father, as I release this job, I lay my hand on this job that I've seen in the realms of the spirit. Let this job show up speedily in the physical. It is done. I don't know how many of you have told God, I just want more of you. Like, I just want to love you. I want to live for you. I want to love you. I want to know you. I want to know you. Have you ever prayed and told God, Father, any man or woman that will limit me from doing your work, take them away from me? Have you ever prayed and told God, any man or woman that will stop me from doing your will, take them away from me? I don't want no man that will stop me from doing the will of God. I don't want no friend that will stop me from doing the will of God. I don't want no children that will stop me from doing the will of God. Any man or woman, any friend, distant or near, that will stop me from doing the work of God, Father, take them away from me in the name of Jesus. Have you ever prayed that prayer? This year, last year we did, Father, Lord, release my documents. Last year we had a program for 7 days. Father, Lord, release my document. We had a program, Father, Lord, release my marriage, 7 days. We had a program, Father, Lord, release my job. Release my job, release my marriage, release my documents. 21 days program, 7 day each. And we also have 40 days of midnight prayer in Evan Chapel. And that's notwithstanding the 21 days of fasting in the beginning of the year. I host all of this program. They are sacrifice for me to sit and host those programs. But I do it because it was the ministry that God gave me. It was through that program, Father, Lord, release my marriage. So many of my children have been married today. Cynthia is number one. The other two ladies, they are there. Father, Lord, release my marriage was when my other daughter got pregnant. It was still from that program. It is from Father, Lord, release my documents that Mira had her documents. And so many of them who are here and who have even left, they had their papers. It was on this same broadcast that Celestian in Italy had his papers. So many people I cannot count. The other one, it was that they have deported him. They told him to pack his bag and go. How many of you remember him? They told him to pack his bag and leave the country. He came on the broadcast and the Lord used me. And I prayed. I said, bring your bag. He brought his bag. I said, pack, he pack. I said, unpack, he unpack. I said, go. You will never leave this country. And he was there. So many people that I cannot count. Some people, if God blesses you, you don't want to share your testimony, and then you message me, I will not pray for you again. If God blesses you and you don't share your testimony, I will not pray for you again. If you're on my broadcast and you don't share the video, Elin Basa Basa, no share on your name. Mesa Brown, no share on your name. Elena Petros, no share on your name. Kesha Smith, no share on your name. La Presi, no share on your name. The day you will send me inbox and say, woman of God, pray for me, I will not pray for you. Because you were on this broadcast, you did not share. How do you want God to release blessing for you if you are ashamed of God? You cannot receive where you did not sow. So if you are coming for me to pray for you, me, I am a praying woman. Everybody knows that. You cannot be in my life. You cannot be in my life for 3 months without a change of story. I tell people, if you are here for 3 months, God did not bless you, please don't watch me again. Go. I have a probation period for you. Some of you, by just drinking the water, your lives are changed. Some of you, you see me in your dream. Some of you, so many things. My daughter Fechi, she was there in the UK. The day I called my daughter was doing shakara for me. She said, I called her. I said, why are you doing like that? She did not believe me. She was just looking at me. She said, this woman with her lipstick and her hair like this. This one too, she's doing God's work. I'm sure she was teasing. And I called her. I told her what the Lord said. I said, madam, I am seeing you. You are not. Your work is you do today. Before you do again in 2 weeks, that one is not work. If God gives you a job that you will work and you will be tired of working, what will you do? Will you come and testify? My daughter was laughing. I said to the people, I said, her faith is not strong, but I am going to use my faith and receive for her. I used my faith and I received for her. 1 week after, she came back with a testimony. She said, Mommy, I have been walking and walking and walking and walking. I am tired, oh. She said, she's tired. I said, you're tired. She said, she's tired. I said, no. You want a walk? Walk. Up till today, she's still a faithful tither in Heaven Chapel. Just tell God, Father, give me a job in this ministry and I will be faithful in my tithing. She does not miss her tithe because she remembers how it used to be for her when she will walk this week. Before she will walk again in 2 weeks, in 1 week, she will be calling them for shifts. They will be posting her. But after I prayed for her, they were calling her for hours. Now she's tired of picking up hours. My God is alive. This live broadcast that we are doing, when Facebook was allowing me to call people on camera, people will be watching. By this time, I'll be having 275 people watching, 315 people watching. But now, look at how many people, 75 people watching. Sometimes 30-something, sometimes 40-something. But I am not moved. You guys know that I am a strong woman. I say, even if I come on the live broadcast and I see one person, me, I will do broadcast. But if the devil says that I will stop the ministry that God gave me, I did not know about Facebook Live. God told me. And the very first day I went live, I did not know that I was live. I was shouting, am I live? Am I live? With all my braids and my nightgown on the bed like that. I didn't know how to do live before. I've never done it. God said to me, pick your phone, go live. I went live. And that broadcast, I was supposed to delete it because my breast was open. But because it was the first broadcast that God led me to do, I refused to remove it. I prayed and so many lives were transformed. So, do not despise the day of your small beginning. Sometimes it's a trick of the devil so that you will not be delivered, you will not be saved. If you're coming to Heaven Chapel, I want you to come with your faith. Don't leave your faith at home and come here. Carry your faith and come here and you will receive. Believe in your heart that anything that is said is for you and you will receive. Share the broadcast when you come in and they say, Shay, Shay. When you come in and they say, Shay, Shay. I see somebody right now. As I was talking, I see you. You have applied for your document the first time, you were rejected. You applied the second time, you were rejected. This time around, you want to go and apply. The Lord says it shall be granted. I am talking to somebody. You have applied for your document the first time, you were denied. They told you to appeal. You went, now you have applied for the appeal. You were still denied. And now the lawyer is still telling you that he's going to try again for you. Tell him to try. It will be successful. So, I can never give up. They have fought me. There's nothing they have not told me. They have carried my naked picture. They have put on social media. They have carried my name. They have put on social media. They have carried my ministry. Put on social media. They have sent people to come. Still this Heaven Chapel. They even send people. Some people that I even prayed for, they went somewhere, they talk against me, evil, and it still came back to me. The day has not come, you will reap the fruit of your labor. But you see me. You see me, Heaven Chapel. You see me, Heaven Chapel, as I'm sitting down here. I am untouchable. I am unmovable. If you think that you will tarnish my image so that I can quit the work of God, you are a liar. If you think that you will go to news, even if you bring me to Calgary Television Center, CTV in Calgary, you are wasting your time. I will not stop. Thank God that in Canada there is freedom of worship. Thank God that in a country where I am a citizen, let me tell you something. When you are looking for my trouble, One thing at the back of your mind should be that I am not just a Nigerian, I am a Canadian. I am not just what? A Nigerian, I am a Canadian. So when you look for my trouble and you think that you can reduce me, my dear, you are going down. You are reducing yourself because it will take you years to get to where I am. It will take you years to get to where I am. I did not get to where I am by work. I got to where I am by grace. So if for you to be able to get to where I am, make sure that your grace is more powerful than my own. I'm not moved by what I hear. I'm not moved by what I see. I'm not moved by the things I hear. Hallelujah. I'm only moved by the word of the Lord. Hallelujah. I'm not moved by the things I see. Hallelujah. I'm only moved by the word of the Lord. Hallelujah. Sing hallelujah. Sing hallelujah. Sing hallelujah. Amen. 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 I am not moved by what I hear. I am not moved by the things I see. I am not moved by the things you do. I am not moved by what you put on the social media about me. I am not moved by what you are saying. I am not even moved by the things you are doing. Me, as I'm sitting down here. I have a thick skin for God. I have made up my mind. I've made up my mind to do God's will for the rest of my life. I've made up my mind to go God's way for the rest of my life. So Satan, get behind me because I have made up my mind. You know when somebody has made up their mind? You know when you have made up your mind, you don't have no way to go. If I had a plan B, it would have been okay. I don't have a plan B. I don't have another option. I don't have another way to go. So no matter what you do, if you like, put me on the billboard. You are announcing me for your glory. Lord, I will do anything just to see you and behold you as my king. Daddy, I wanna be where you are. I have made up my mind to be with God. So if you like, talk rubbish. If you like, talk good. If you like, if in every 100, 2 people talk bad about me, 80 people will speak good about me, because God has used me to help people. God has used me to deliver people. God has used me. Who did you see? Who is it? Before you see a true man of God or a true woman of God, they pass through tribulation. If you've never been anywhere on Facebook, you're not true. If you did not fall, you are not true. I used to do broadcasts. When I finished my broadcast, how many viewers? My children, 35,000 viewers, 30,000 viewers, 20,000 viewers, 27,000 viewers. They started to fight just so that I would do what? I would calm down. They said all manner of things so that I would calm down. When you people see who is fake, you will not know. But you see me. If I have ever carried anointing oil that is not pure and put in my hand, let my anointing disappear. But if I have never, let the Lord increase me with more anointing every day. If the Bible I'm carrying it in spirit and in truth. If this is the only book of God that I know, I am not reading the book of Mammon. I am not reading the book of spiritualists. I am not reading the book of cultists. I have never stood in the way of unrighteousness. I have never known no marine spirit or whatever. Let the Lord increase my anointing. But if I know any of these things, let the Lord take my life tonight. Let the Lord take my life tonight. But if I don't, let the Lord increase me. You see a pure woman of God. You see a woman of grace. You see a woman on fire. You see a praying champion. Instead of you to celebrate and tap, you are there. Following people that are frustrated. Look at the people who are talking about me. Look at their lives. Look at my life. That is how to answer idiotic people. When you look at the people who are talking about other people, you look at their life, and you look at the life of the people they are talking about, then you begin to weigh it and say, ah, how come you're talking about someone and your life is like this? And look at how their life is. Whilst you're talking about me, God is busy lifting me. While you are talking about me, God is busy blessing me in front of you. While you are busy condemning me, God is elevating me right before you. I come and the viewers are more. I come and the people are celebrating. First lady, it's not easy. It's not easy to be the first lady of God. It's not easy. It comes with stories, right? You can imagine the first lady of the US. She goes through so many things. It's not easy. People would talk about you. People would condemn you. They condemned Jesus. Jesus was not accepted when he came on earth. So if you are of God, you don't need to be accepted. In fact, if you're loved by everybody, then your life is questionable. You need to question your life. If you're loved by everybody, you need to question yourself. My dear children, I always tell you people something. I say, cook chicken and eat. Cook chicken and eat. Drink malt. Cook chicken, eat. Drink malt. Drink milk in Quaker. Make your life beautiful. Love the people that love you. Look for people that love you. Look for people that love you. Be with them. Talk to them. I appreciate those people that cannot go a day without me. God bless you. Those of you that cannot go a day without me, may the Lord bless you. Those of you that always check up on me. Those of you that knows that it is not easy to carry the burdens of the old world. Those of you that always say to me, Mommy, more grace. Those of you that come to my inbox and say, Mommy, even at last, may the Lord bless you. Those of you that says, Mommy, how are you doing? May the Lord bless you. Because it's not easy. It's not easy. There are days I sit on my bed replying messages. I don't ignore anybody. God that called me knows that I am the humblest person on earth. I am humble. When you say a woman is down to earth, I am. Ask the people who know me. I am down to earth. There are people that you cannot even go to their room. You cannot go to their room to sit on their bed. When I go for programs, my children lie on my bed. They come into my room because I am not hiding anything. I am not hiding anything. They take my bag. They do anything. I want to eat with them. I want them to even come and spend the night, stay with me. Because I'm not hiding anything. I am very humble. It does not mean because God has blessed me. It does not mean that because I'm a medical doctor. It does not mean because I'm a Canadian citizen. It does not mean that because my life is colorful. It does not mean that because I have the gift, therefore I need to press people down with it. No. No. The one I cannot do is calling. I cannot call. That's why I will not disappoint you. I know that I am not good with calling. That is why I don't do call. Even my parents, I don't call them. They call me because I am not good with calling. And if you call me two times, you are disturbing me. I don't like it. People will take, when I finish my program and my daughter Aisha is there, I always take 10% of what God has blessed me with and give to Aisha. Any money that I give to Aisha, that means that is the percentage that I made. The two programs that I went, I bless Aisha. My 10%, after counting all the offering, I give to Aisha. Aisha will lie on my leg. Aisha will climb on my body. Aisha will carry everything. Oh my God. I will be praying. They will be telling her, Aisha, you allow mommy to rest now. Aisha will not allow me. My hair, my makeup, everywhere. Aisha will scatter me, disorganize me before my program. And after my program, oh, she's the baby. One leg, one hand, rubbing. Oh, my God. I say, yes, Aisha, don't worry. Tomorrow I'll be gone. You will not see me again. So play. Do as you like. So, it is humility. But people who don't understand, a man once told me, he said, when he looks at me from a distance, I look very tough. I look very hard. And I just laugh. But when you come close to me, when you come close to me, you will know that I am the simplest woman that ever lived. I don't have single pride. I don't have simple. I don't have single it's not me. I am down to earth, simple, unique in my own way. So it's just who I am. Sometimes I wish I could change, because then people take advantage. Behind the strong woman you're seeing is a woman with tears. I always cry. When people have issues, I cry. When God is delaying to answer people's prayer, I cry. I'm very emotional. I put my leg into people's shoe. I understand every situation. I have never judged nobody, because I know it is by grace that we are saved. We are all sinners, but we are careful sinners. The only difference that I'm better than you is because I'm a careful sinner. I sin with caution. I sin and know that this is a sin. But other people sin carelessly. But before I sin, I say, oh no, I'm not supposed to do this thing. God help me so that I don't do this thing. But people don't care. So please, let us come back to the place of worship. Let us come back to the place of togetherness. Let us come back to the place of loving God. Let us come back to the place of possessing that which the devil took from us. How are we going to take back what the devil has taken from us? It is by prayer. It is by supplication. Prayer, supplication, humility. Forgive one another. Don't bear crutches on your fellow member. Don't put anybody to heart. Love people. No matter what somebody does to you, forgive. The best way that God can answer your prayer speedily is forgiving. If you have a forgiving spirit, your life will be so colorful. If you have the spirit to forgive, no matter what happened, forgive. Forgiving people does not mean accepting them back home. Forgive and let go. It does not mean you should stay with them. You can forgive and move on. You can forgive and take them back, but don't put it to heart. It will hinder your blessing. Don't put people to your heart. It will limit you. Don't put people to your heart. It will block your receiving from God. Don't put people to your heart. It will stop your days of breakthrough. Forgive. Forgive. Let go and let God. Sometimes it is hard to forgive. I gave a lady money. The lady took the money. She said she was going to refund the money to me, but she never did. She took the money, and that was it. She never refunded the money to me. She did not do anything. And instead, anytime she sees me, she begins to talk about me after she took my money. Anytime she sees me, she begins to talk about me after she took my money. Anytime she sees me, she begins to talk about me after she took my money. So I just told myself, you know what? I don't want to be hurt. I always beg people that come into my life. I say, please don't hurt me. You know why I'm begging you not to hurt me? Because when you hurt me, so many things will go wrong for you. So I will beg you and say, please do not hurt me. If you know that you're going to hurt me, just leave me alone and go. But don't be the reason why I'm sorrowful. Don't be the reason why I'm not happy. Don't be the reason why I'm crying. Because God counts my tears. Like, you affect me, right? I'm not going to be able to pray for others. I'm not going to be able to come online. I'm not going to be able to do so many things. But I'm a strong woman. I always pull through it all. So if I see that you're going to hurt me, I just pull out. Especially when I'm dating people that are in Africa, or people that have 2 hours different than me, or people that have 5-6 hours different from me, time difference from me, and you are doing competition with me in love, you can't check up on me. You have passed the stage of looking for a man. My man should look for me. If you want me, you will fight for me. If you love me, you will fight for me. That's the truth. But if you're sitting down and you're doing competition with me and you want to talk to me when you like, I am not desperate. I will not mind you. I will ignore you so that you will know that I am not just that desperate woman who is waiting for your message, waiting for your call. No. It's not pride, but it's just guiding my heart. It's protecting who I am, right? because I know who I am. I am not that strong woman. I am that emotional woman. So I have to protect myself from being broken, from being miserable, from being sad. I have to protect my heart. It's my heart. I have to protect it. I have to guide it with all diligence. If I don't love myself, I cannot love you. So for me to love you, that means I love myself. May the Lord help us in Jesus' mighty name. So I'm going to go now, and I will see you when I see you, but hopefully soonest I will see you. I know people like you when I have the live broadcast every day. Tomorrow is Sunday. By the grace of God, we shall fellowship together. We might worship together. I don't know which day we cannot have the live broadcast. So, because when I'm on for God. Tomorrow we will worship together. We will fellowship together tomorrow. Please follow my timeline. Follow the page and pray so that you can see when I will be live. And please, when you are going to church, remain some shares and know that I'll be coming online tomorrow so that you can also share. Okay? Just leave, save some live lines for Evan Chapel so that when we come online, you'll be able to share. Okay? And one more thing that I wanted to say is about the book. If you have not gotten your testimony album yet, please make sure you get your testimony album. Just message me for your copy and I will send it to wherever you are. And Monday is our general fasting. If you have not been following the Monday program, please follow the Monday program. It is very life transforming. The Monday fasting is so life transforming. God has transformed so many people's life from that Monday fasting. So please endeavor to be a part of that Monday fasting so that God can bless you. Endeavor to be a part of that Monday program and God can bless you. 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 Yes, I was watching the news. And I saw that tomorrow is Mother's Day in UK. So happy Mother's Day to all my daughters in the UK. Yes, I was watching the news. That's why I stated from the beginning that it is Mother's Day. Don't say, I want to go and visit my mother. Stay home and stay safe. You can do a video call with mommy. There will always be another Mother's Day. Stay home and stay safe. Happy Mother's Day to you, Ami Samuela. Maria, Fechi, Esther, so many people. I actually have so many daughters in the UK. You guys are a lot, Idoreyen, Ememetim. You guys are a lot in the UK. Okay, so happy Mother's Day to you guys. I'll be wishing you guys happy Mother's Day tomorrow by the grace of God. But let me be the first to wish you happy Mother's Day. It's a blessing being a mother. It wasn't a mistake for God to make you a woman. You are beautiful. You are beautiful just the way you are. You are beautiful just the way you are. The sky's so beautiful. This is your beautiful. So you guys are beautiful. You're wonderful. You're blessed. God made you. God made you a mother because he knows that, you know, you are wonderfully, fearfully made. So I celebrate you. I celebrate all of you. Tomorrow I'll be live and I'll still say a happy Mother's Day to you guys. It's a great feeling. Wow, Maria was still here. Wow, you guys are so wonderful. I just love you guys. I didn't even know that she was still watching. My God, she has been from on the broadcast from the beginning to the end. You know, you guys really try though. You guys always try. Like, it's not easy just watching somebody talking for 2 hours and all of that. I really appreciate you guys, but you guys don't know. I love you from my heart. You see this, my love, eh? Since I started live broadcast, I used to tell you people I love you. It is now that people are copying me. When they are doing live broadcast, they say, I love you, I love you, I love you. It is me. Me. I started it. I love you guys. And I'm not joking. I love you guys. Like, I love you guys. Even when you guys are hurting me, I love you guys. Even when I am crying, I love you guys. Because without you guys, the work of God will be hard for me. Without you guys, who am I going to minister to? Some of you became who you are because of me. God used me to mold your lives to who you are. Some of you, you were prayerless when you met me. But because of me, your prayer life bounced back. Because of me, you learned to forgive. Because of me, there are so many things you have learned from me. So if you say you have not learned something from me, you are not honest. So I just appreciate you guys sitting down, lying down, sharing, and reacting to the video, supporting. It's not easy. 2 hours, 3 hours. Sometimes my back will be hurting. I will still be doing the live broadcast. What can I do? You must pray. It is you that God called. Thank God for the good children that he gave me, sons and daughters who are there from the beginning to the end to support me. Where will I go? What will I do? It's not easy. Hey. So I really appreciate every one of you. And sometimes you're celebrating your birthday. I don't have the time to tell you. But if however, Mesha Brown said, I learned a lot from you, mommy. God bless you, my daughter. If however, I am not able to. If however, you are celebrating your birthday and I'm not able to wish you a happy birthday, please. Don't say that mommy has some people that she wishes happy birthday. No. You see those people that I'm wishing happy birthday. They tell me, mommy, tomorrow is my birthday. And they send a picture to me. And I will post the picture and I will tell everybody to wish them happy birthday. So if you want to be celebrated in Heaven Chapel, please send me your picture. Tell me and I will share your picture and everybody will wish you a happy birthday. Because on my own birthday, all of you must wish me. It's not just mommy happy birthday. You will take my beautiful picture. You will do message. You will write message. You will do videos. And you will flaunt my timeline. Flaunt my timeline with birthday wishes. Birthday, 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 birthday wishes. Birthday wishes, birthday wishes, birthday, birthday, birthday. And you will make videos for me. And make me proud that day. Make me happy. Last year I cried. Last year on my birthday, I cried. I know this year I will cry again because it's always so emotional for me seeing all the love, seeing all the care and all of that. It's just amazing. I don't know where I will go to celebrate my birthday, but hopefully the pandemic will be over and one of my daughters or my sons will plan something for me. Last year, it was in California. Odile, Mama Odile did it for me. And her prayer has always been that God should bless her so that she would do it in a more bigger way for me. Yesterday, 2 days ago, she wrote on the post and I read it. I was like, God, she's just so soft in the heart. Wow, Samela said UK. Hey, 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 hey. I'm dancing already. I'm dancing like a winner, mano. I'm dancing like a winner, mano. Hey, Samela said in the UK. Yes, Father, I release support, finances, open doors so that it will come to pass in the mighty name of Jesus. Amen. Okay, guys. So I will go now. I will go and rest. Feel free to message me. Whatever you're going through, don't go through pains alone. I am here for you. My shoulder is here for you to lean on. I am never tired. Don't say, mommy, it's midnight. I cannot message you. The only thing you cannot call, you can message me. Sometimes I'm sleeping. If the Holy Spirit wants me, and if it is, you need to know my time difference in Canada. You need to put Canada time in your clock, a Calgary, Alberta, in your wall clock. Like me, I have wall clock for some countries. I have wall clock for some countries, you see? You see that? I have Ottawa, I have Nigeria, I have UK, I have all those time. So when I want to send a message, I just go and I look. I see that, wow, it's 11:56 p.m. in Nigeria now. 11:56 p.m. in UK. 10:56 in Ghana. Cameroon, like that. Cotonou, I have all those time. So I check it and I know what to do. I send a message. So if you know my time, especially at midnight when I'm praying and you message me, I just put your case into my midnight prayer and pray. If you message me during my midnight, time me because I do midnight every night. Time me during my midnight. I start my midnight from 12 and sometimes it can last to 2 hours, 3 hours, 4 hours. It all depends on how the Lord leads me and the case I have to deal with. So there are cases that I have to deal and attack it one after the other. There are people that I need to call them in the realms of the spirit and talk to them one and one and ask you, what is the problem with my daughter? What is the problem with my son? Who are you? Who is sending you? Why are you doing this? I need to table them in the realm of the spirit. So such cases can take me time, but I must get answers before I go to sleep. When I table you, when I call you, you must give me feedback. So whether they have assembled in your village, wherever they have gathered, when I call them, they will tell me what the problem is before I let them go. So if I have such cases, it takes me time before I go back to sleep. So if you time me during that time and you message me, I just key in your prayer request. But aside of that, 247, I'm interceding for you. I pray for the titles. I pray for the sowers. I pray for people that come on the broadcast, the ones I know their problems, the ones that are looking for documents, the ones that are believing God for divine settlement, restoration in broken homes, all those things. I just begin to pray at night, call them for God to settle their cases. So sometimes it's not because your name is not being called, it means I'm not praying for you. No, there are some underground battles that is going on for you, underground prayer that is going on for you. I have a list of people that I'm praying for, and the list is always in the Bible here. I have it in my Bible here. I'm praying for them, and anytime it seems as though things are not, some people, when God answers it, I just drop it and I move into the next prayer point. There are so many people, when God answers it, I remove that one, I move into the next. So you need to always covet your prayer. You need to covet your request. You need to covet your request. You need to covet your request. The Bible says, write the vision and make it plain. Say, pray for me. Pray for you about what? Pray for you concerning what? The Holy Spirit knows. What if the Holy Spirit wants to settle you maritally and you don't want maritally now? You want to go to school. You want admission. So it's always good for you to write the vision and make it plain. The Holy Spirit knows your problem. Some people, you're believing God for a house, but what God wants to do for you is for God to give you marriage, and you're not ready for that marriage. So it's always good to tell your heart desire, the things you want God to do for you. You just state it. I want God to do this for me. And the person will pray about it. And when we pray a prayer of agreement, the Lord will surely do it. May the Lord bless you. May the Lord make his face to shine for you. May the Lord fight your battles for you. May the Lord give you victory. May the Lord break the yoke upon thy neck. May the Lord remove the burden upon thy shoulder and make his face to shine for you. Happy blessed night. Happy beautiful Saturday night. As you sleep, sleep in the Lord. May the Lord send his angels to encamp around you. May the Lord release his shield and to cover you all night. Good morning, good afternoon, good evening, good night, wherever you're watching me from. It was a privilege for me to have you. Until we gather again tomorrow by God's special grace, I wish you heaven at last. I love you. I love you. I love you guys so very much. Let us share the grace of fellowship together. Now may the grace of our Lord Jesus Christ and the love of God and the sweet fellowship of the Holy Spirit rest and abide with us now and forevermore. Amen. Surely God's goodness and mercy shall follow us all the days of our life, and we shall dwell in the house of the Lord, celebrating forever and ever. Amen and amen. Heaven at last is what I wish you. Until I see you again tomorrow, I love you. Shalom.